Alright. It said, okay, I had to hit go live.
Ah, yes,
I had
okay.
to push the go live button physically. That was
But we're here now. Hello.
Yes, we are. Okay, now I need to get back to the stream. Okay.
And I'm going to mute the version of the stream because okay. I don't want to hear everything we say twice.
That, might have to trim that a little in post. But, here we are. We've got, welcome to the demo. Welcome to the press demo for Cattails Wildwood Story. This is a very early build of the game. There's plenty more features and content planned while the game is in development. Thank you so much for checking out our project. Please feel free to get in touch if you have any feedback. You can follow our journey on Twitter at Cattails Game. I hope you'll enjoy your time with the demo, says Tyler.
Thank you, Tyler.
So here we go. I'm gonna push OK. I actually have not opened this at all yet. So let's go for it. Oh god.
Oh boy. Maybe we should have planned this at all. Okay. Who are we making?
A cute flower name. Sunny, go.
Petunia. That's a horrible name. I like Petunia, actually. No, let's stick with it. That I'm committing.
Okay. Alright, time to customize our appearance. Which we have a lot of options for.
There are presets, which would probably be more time effective.
They would. Or...
Or...
You know.
We could throw it away and just customize everything.
Well, let's look at a couple of these. Here's the the Bengal.
Oh.
Ooh, you got little leopard star spots on this guy.
But that's adorable.
Cream tabby. Eh. Purple.
Literally purple cat.
Dark stripe.
That is dark stripe. That is a very dark stripe color. Ruddy.
It's interesting. Okay. Ruddy usually designates a black based cat. Gray and white. Let's see. Orange calico.
I mean, I obviously am drawn to that, but no.
Jay Feather. Alright, How about we make a copy of one of these guys.
And alter a bit?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see. Head, huh? Oh, this just changed.
Oh, that's just the head. Okay.
So we can mess with these all a lot, very separately from each other.
Very, oh wow, okay.
Oh, you can make it very
That,
green.
Oh okay. my. So we could be an alien cat, or we could be normal in any way.
Alright, so let's see. If we make the head the same color as the body here, just to be even. 105. 5 10 10 Okay, I can use the keyboard to adjust them.
That might be easier, yeah.
There we go. Okay. So now all of those are the right color. Well, the color that we've arbitrarily chosen.
I somehow hadn't noticed the 1 through 6 options at the top and thought the base was the only thing that was adjustable. I'm very observant. So,
what color do you think a Petunia is?
Well, realistically, it's like a blue purplish most of the time. So, Russian blue cat?
Alright, we'll go for.
Or something else.
We'll take the blue, but then we'll, desaturate it.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, I think there's okay. Yeah, S for saturation, maybe. Yeah.
And V for value. I can artwork. Okay. Let's see. I somehow made the head a different color, but you know what? We could probably...
This is fine. This is perfectly fine.
You just have a white head.
Petunia doesn't need to follow any rules.
Let's put this in the yellowish kind of... Not the green, the yellowish kind of white. Okay. Now we've got patterns. Which are stripes.
Oh, kill the stripes. No stripes. Tabbies are bad.
Mm-hmm. Tabbies are bad?
Tabby's bad. Tabby's very bad.
So we're not gonna... We are anti-tabby.
Very anti-tabby. I'm a strict anti-tabby. There are far too many of them.
Well, see, I accidentally kind of made the stripes...
Well, okay, you know, we'll pretend those are also patches.
Okay, so patches. What? Alright, so here's patches too. Which are the things that were there to begin with.
Ah, okay, okay.
Let's put it more in the red spectrum.
Oh, that's pretty.
Oh, brown. Brown.
Brown and blue.
I hecking love brown. I already messed up. I messed up already with what I think that I'm willing to say on this stream.
To be fair, it was in a whisper.
Nice desaturated reddish brown. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Sorry, now I'm just sitting here trying to get it perfect.
Absolutely fine.
Okay. This stripes too, I think, is off. We want this on 181 as well as... No, do we? I'm trying to make them invisibler. Okay, doesn't matter. Let's see. Patterns 2. Head stripes. We'll leave that wherever the heck it is, I think. Belly. Let's make the belly cream like the patch on the head.
Oh, that would be nice, yeah. There are certain aspects of this that are reminding me of myself, but this is fine. Completely different colors.
I'm sorry.
This is fine.
you can self-insert on the
I am Petunia.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna go with these are probably not gonna be like perfect copies of the other colors, but oh, this is just the cheek color, basically, so I'm gonna try and also make that whitish. Yeah, the muzzle.
Kinda... Oh.
This is pretty. And... Not a design that would show up on any cat ever, but it's pretty.
Well, you know, cats don't exist, so...
Cats don't exist!
We truly can do whatever we would like, I think. It's a big nose they've got here. Alright, that's I guess a pink nose, because it is white.
Nose!
Now, am I?
Oh, you can change the inner ear color separately.
I think the ear color is fine.
Yeah.
But, you know what? No. I'm gonna mess with that.
Oh, wow. You can have neon blue ears.
It's only the inside of the ear, so... Try and make it match the
eye color technically.
But then oh, there we go, there's the outside of the ear.
Oh.
Alright, so let's brown.
Okay, well, the brown half of the face thing is on the wrong side, but this is definitely a Sunnyfall marking.
Well, then I'm gonna make the other ear white. Are we going to pick our cat's traits too? I don't know. I don't know yet.
I have no idea.
I haven't messed with this. I haven't messed with this at all yet. Okay.
Oh, the feetsies. Cats don't, in fact, exist. It's a conspiracy.
I'll try to make all of these little brown feet. This is not how tortoiseshell works, just so everyone knows.
Yeah.
A tortoiseshell cat cannot be made out of two black-based colors, but today we do not care.
Today you can make neon purple or blue or green cats. So, you know, tortoiseshell with blue and brown is perfectly fine. I don't see any problem with that. I think you needed to backspace the rest of the name first. Yeah.
Oh, I can just type it in myself. Okay, you know what? Fine. That's fine. That's an acceptable way to type something. There we go. Wear it. Now let's...
Whee! Oh my gosh, there's accessories and eye colors. Oh. Perfect, yes.
Well, hold on.
Bright red demon eyes.
Well, if we desaturate them a little, they turn into a little pink demon eyes. How's about that?
That's great. You know, it's a subtle type of demon. You're not really sure if she's a demon or not until she attacks you. Of course, she has a little flower. Lovely.
Okay. Spring 5 is also my birthday, I think. Do you consider March to be spring, or do you consider it to be winter?
Well, it's definitely the borderline month. I think mentally, I still consider it to be winter.
So, like, maybe like winter 5.
Winter 5, good. Game difficulty. Oh boy.
Okay. Normal. Quick time. Yeah, I prefer that because the randomness of the other game. Random enemies on. Yeah, okay. Everything seems
good. Let's do this.
Seems good. We're finally in the game. Once upon a time, three great cat colonies lived in a plentiful land. I'm guessing this was the first game.
Probably.
For generations, they thrived, hunting the critters of the region and harvesting the fruits of the forest. That's a little morbid. Sometimes, the colonies bickered and fought, but each of their leaders shared a respect for the spiritual mediator of the world, the Forest Guardian. The world of the Guardian was law, and all cats revered them. From the sacred temple, the Guardian kept balance over the cat lands, working for the benefit of all. The cats of the forest thrived. This is cute. This artwork is really, really cute.
It's beautiful, yeah.
They played in the meadows and ruled over the hills. They built strong walls and gathered prey for winter. But one fateful day, calamity struck. In an instant, the temple was shattered. A terrible earthquake tore the stones from their ancient resting places. All that work we did in the first game, it's gone. Just from one
lightning. Taken away in an instant.
A horrible rift was ripped open in the ground. Every cat shuddered with fear. Worse than the destruction of the land was the fading of its guardian. With a weak voice, the forest guardian announced that the land was no longer safe for any cat. A new home must be found, and a new temple must be built, or else the guardian's spirit would not survive. Then the spirit of the guardian flickered and vanished. The frightened cats mourned and did not know what to do. A great meeting was called, and all the cats of the forest attended. Together, they
Together, they deliberated over what must be done.
Thank you for saving my life.
Not a problem. The decision was reached that each cat should choose for themselves a leader to follow and set out to find new lands to settle. Maybe some would have the strength to build a better life. You, Petunia, a cat of great renown, offered to lead a group into the unknown and build both a new home and a new temple. Soon, cats from every colony took up your call. Once enemies, now united by a common cause, you all set out to find a patch of earth to call your own. But the wilderness is fraught with danger, and there are threats on all sides. What will become of your colony? Will you lead them into a prosperous new era? Will you find the perfect place to build a home? Only time will tell.
Cattails. Here we are. We got a couple super chats. Lavin Blush says, "Hey, just want to say I love the content you both make. Expect more fan art in the future." And Blood Hush says, "I am sprinkling some love onto this stream."
Thank you both.
Okay. Oh, when we leave her alone, she starts sitting and watching
us. Oh, that's adorable. I see you have mail.
Okay. I need to remember the controls. Okay. We've got walk around. The enter button does nothing. The space bar attacks things. All right, let's attack the mailbox. Edie. Okay.
We made it!
Oh, this is Coco.
Oh, so this is me. Mm-hmm. Hello, Petunia. Well, we finally arrived. This is our new home now. Isn't it amazing? Let's all do our part to ensure success now that we've chosen a spot to settle down. I couldn't be more excited to see what's in store for us all. Sincerely, Coco.
Oh, and there's Coco again.
Hi, Coco.
He sent me mail even though he lives two steps outside my house.
It's just considerate to leave people letters, you get it? Petunia, I was hoping to catch you. I just wanted you to know that if you ever need to carry out any sort of administrative task, I'm your cat. Come talk to me if you want to manage the colony, and I'll help you get everything sorted.
Do you think maybe I should move the two guys in the corners?
That is, in fact, covering the
it's
beginning
covering
of the dialogue.
A little bit of text. So I'm gonna put them at the top of the screen. That's my new plan. transform, rotate 180 degrees. This is normal. Transform, rotate 180 degrees. There we go. Now we'll disrupt the gameplay of Cattails Less.
That's perfect. I love being up here. Now then, did you have something important to discuss?
Let's manage some colony details.
Yes, I think that's a great idea. You want to manage the details of the colony? What did you have in mind?
Oh boy.
Oh. Oh my. Oh boy.
It can be really
what is our colony called?
Violent. We had blood, we had blight.
Yeah.
What do you think, Sunny?
Oh, hi, Bagheera. I probably should have shut the door. Yeah. She doesn't meow, but she does jingle. Okay. Is this our thing, or is it Petunia's thing? Are we connecting it to celestial bodies or to flowers?
What kind of person do you think Petunia is? Do you think she likes flowers? Do you think she called herself Petunia?
Oh, that's true. She was probably named Petunia by someone else. You know, I'm not sure she does like flowers. What's the opposite of a flower? I think it's a tree.
Tree colony.
What's a nice tree?
Oh, wait, I've got a good one.
Okay, go ahead.
Oh my god, I've got caps lock on.
Oh, and thank you, Shami! Perfect. Yes, I know what you're going with. Grass-eating colony. Oh, boy.
Grass-eating kingdom.
Grass-eating kingdom. That is much better. Colony emblem.
We live outside. We eat grass.
Oh
we...
my gosh, there's one with a volcano.
We destroy the natural wildlife population as an invasive species.
Sounds lovely. Perfect. Oh, that's a tree. Perfect.
A tree.
We're good. That's it. Yep. Very nice. I'll get those changes filed right away, and make sure to notify everybody. You'll now be known as the leader of the grass-eating kingdom. I am so glad that I get to say that every time I talk to you now. This is going to be great.
Oh, my markings, they jingle a little, they wiggle a little bit around as I walk. It looks kind of like I've got kind of like a little flowing...
ripple thing, yeah. Like a series of clouds across your back.
Got Ellie down
oh
here.
Frick, it's it, no, Eli's me too.
Hi there. Lovely day to lounge about, don't you think? I'm Eli, in case you had forgotten. Sorry if that sounded rude, it's just that remembering names is kind of my thing. If you're ever unhappy with your name, come and see me. I can change it for you. Now that we're neighbors, I'm sure we'll be seeing each other more often. If you're ever in the mood for a quick chat, just say so. I'd love to get to know you better. I'm always free to chat. If you're looking to make a new friend, you've come to the right cat. That rhymed! So tell me about yourself, Petunia. Where are you from?
I have nothing to say to you, apparently. I guess we were all
kind of
from the same
place. I mean, I asked you a question,
place.
But, I mean, you don't have to answer. Just come back anytime!
Whoa! Are you trying to sneak up on me? Who are you? Oh, you're Petunia. I heard about you. Fair warning, I advise you to try and stay on my good side. I don't like sneaks.
I don't like you.
Wow. I may be elderly, but that doesn't mean I'm useless. Go ahead, try me in a fight. Let's see who wins. Any place, any time.
You know, you don't make a good first impression, Talon. You should be more like Eli.
I relate with her. I'm also elderly and I fight people.
Gosh darn it, why did I pick every cat? Oh boy. Hey, who are you?
I'm Lainey. Lovely to meet you. I don't know if you've met Fliss yet, but we're siblings. From the same litter, as a matter of fact. That's why we look so alike. Lots of cats get us mixed up, so don't feel bad if you do too at first. Fliss understands me like no other cat ever has. We've been through everything together. We have a lot of other siblings, but the two of us were always especially close, even from a very young age. That's why we moved out here together.
Where's Fliss?
In the den, maybe? I mean, you might not be allowed in there.
Maybe. Let's see if we can go in Lainey's house.
This is Fliss and Lainey's den. Neither of them are expecting you, so you should stay outside until you become more acquainted. There's an identical set of nearly everything inside. Both sides of the interior look almost like a mirror image of the other.
I see. Alright, so this is sneaking. Is there running? Oh my goodness.
Oh, jumping.
Jumping.
Pouncing.
That Q opens my inventory. Okay. Well, let's go see Jag. I like Jag.
Yay!
In fact, the email that sent me this demo said includes includes Jag in parentheses.
Perfect.
Not even kidding.
Well, it's a well-known fact.
I'm Jag. I used to live in the northern mountains back before the move to the Wildwood. Never thought I'd leave home, but here I am. Lots of good memories back there. Hopefully I can make new ones out here and get over it. I'm going to try and keep an eye on things around town for you. Some cats got to keep the peace and watch out for petty crimes and all that. I'll do my best to keep quiet and stay out of your way as I go about my duties. My old colony was a great place to live, until it wasn't. I'm not going to go into detail, okay? Suffice to say, things went south quickly and I got out. If you end up being a poor leader, I won't hesitate to do it again. What did he do? Jag, what did you do?
Unclear, he might have blown up the colony.
Did he lead a coup?
Yeah, it's possible, you know, you don't know what happened.
I can't believe it. Jag is... Jag is,
you know,
already threatening
you think
me.
You know a guy.
Oh, there's Fliss. I'm Fliss, aren't I?
Oh, yeah, you are.
Oh, you must be the leader that everyone's talking about. My name's Fliss. I'm happy to make your acquaintance. Together, my sibling Lainey and I will do everything we can to make the kingdom proud. I promise you that. Speaking of Lainey, you should go meet them too if you haven't already. I'm sure they'll be thrilled to get to know you. I'm flattered that you think I'm interesting enough to chat with. Honestly, I'm just a normal cat. I haven't had a long enough life to have any interesting stories like Crampy or Coco do. I'm hoping this new kingdom business will provide me with plenty of internet experiences. That's why I moved out here in the first place.
You know, I was looking back at the list, and it turns out that you were actually Lainey and I was actually Fliss, but that's fine.
We just traded. Oops.
We just traded. It's fine.
Alright, I have not gone outside. Bob.
Hi, Bob.
You know what I like best about Bob?
What do you like best about Bob?
Looks like Beaver.
This is true.
Well, now, I don't think we've met just yet. Name's Bob. Nice to meet you. Oh, you're the leader! Sorry, I didn't mean to be surprised there. You're just not what I was expecting, is all. Anyhow, it's nice to make your acquaintance. I'll be around if you need me. See you around. Not much has been going on in my life. I've just been taking it a day at a time. That's always been my policy. Put one paw down and then the next. Ain't worth the trouble to look too far ahead.
I like how Bob didn't even invite you to talk. He just said see you around preemptively.
Yeah, he just wants you to go away.
Yeah.
I'm Glimmer?
Yeah.
This is Glimmer's den. Odd runes are carved into the doorway. Out of an abundance of caution, you decide to stay back until you get to know them better. Inside, an eclectic collection of exotic items is strewn everywhere. Is that a pile of gemstones glittering along the back wall?
Ah, Petunia. You've interrupted my scheming. Maybe I'll let you in on my plans.
You are precious and I love you instantly.
We are all obligated to make the most of our days, especially on a clear day like this one. There can be no excuse for laziness.
I agree, Glimmer. You're not very talkative, but I love you.
There are a lot of people in this like town already. Like, I was expecting you to like have to like work up from a couple, but
yeah.
There's like, I mean, maybe in
no.
The real game it will, but there's like 10, 12.
I think you
here.
Also skipped Charlotte down in the bottom right.
Oh, I can go get her.
Yeah. Well, if we're going in a circle, we can also get her at any time you want.
Nope.
I turn around. Okay. Cool. Okay.
I'm swimming for Charlotte.
You can swim! Oh.
You're Petunia? Huh. I thought you'd be taller or something. Not quite what I had in mind. I'm Charlotte. We probably won't see each other around much. I like being alone most of the time. Anyways, I've got a lot of stuff to do, so... yeah. I moved out here to get away from everything and everybody. I thought a place like the Wild would be quiet and lonesome, just how I like it. Now I've got cats like you breathing down my neck left and right. Maybe I made a mistake.
Wow.
Charlotte's a peach.
She's kind of cute, isn't she?
Sure. I'm a pretty black kitty.
Don't think oh, I you're... know you. So, what are you doing here? I'm not interested in buying whatever you're selling, okay? Oh, wait. You're the leader, aren't you? Well, shoot. I didn't expect you to stop by and say hello. Thought you'd have more important things to do. I'm Garlic, and I can't promise you anything. I'm not very good at fighting, or hunting, or anything, really, but I'm here. Anyways, I'll try to stick to myself. If I don't, I'll probably let you down sooner or later. I'm just trying to be realistic.
Oh, Garlic, don't say that.
These darned bugs are everywhere. They keep getting stuck in my fur. How will I get anything done today other than cleaning myself?
I actually kind of like Garlic. Garlic is nice. Oh, this is the mom. This one's me.
Oh, hello there, Petunia. I'm glad you've come by. I'm just about fully set up and all moved in. I run a general goods store called Ember's Emporium. I hope you'll stop by for all your shopping needs. Also, if you see Spark, can you tell them that their shift started an hour ago? Being a parent is tough enough when your kid is so flighty. I used to be a bit of a jokester, but life has a way of beating you down. I've got more important things to do than sit around thinking up funny jokes.
I can fix her.
Becoming a parent is a trial in its own right. Also very rewarding, but it's hard work.
I like Ember. I really like Ember. And there's Spark.
Oh, hey, how's it going? Ember told me a lot of stuff about you. I'm Spark. Maybe we can hang out sometime. I already found some awesome spots to run around and catch bugs. Sorry, did you say something? I totally zoned out.
Spark is also sweet. I like most of these cats. Oh, joy. It's...
I'm Champ. I'm sure you heard of me, so I'll spare you the full introduction. The quick version is that I'm strong, I'm fast, and I'm not gonna let the kingdom down. I heard there was plenty of action out here in the Wildwood, so I want in. Oh, and here I am! Consider yourself lucky, Petunia. The tide's about to turn, and I'll be leading the charge when it does.
Does he want to take our job?
Yes, actually. I really think I should be the leader, but I'm sort of that underdog type of leader. I'm gonna rise up through the ranks based on my own good deeds. You can have it for now. Don't you worry. There's a festival coming up. I've been training all season for it. If you thought you had a chance at taking home some festival tokens, think again. You're gonna be up against some pretty tough competition.
See, Jag implies he was part of a coup. Champ just straight up says that he's willing to lead one.
I am going to lead a coup. I'll get some tips from Jag.
Who are you? Are you looking for me? Are you looking at me? Oh, you're Petunia. I've heard about you. I'll try to stay out of your way. I'm really not much for conversation.
Wow. She's a baby.
Yeah. I don't know how old she is, but I've determined she's a baby anyway.
Me? Yes?
Yeah, you.
Oh, hello. I don't usually see any other cats at this time. I wasn't expecting on seeing anyone, especially a new face. I'm Phantom. Nice to meet you. Do I smell like peppermint? Sorry, it's all over my paws. I've been sorting my herb collection all morning so that it can fit more into my den.
Oh, you're the herb baby. Okay.
It has a habit of expanding into every nook and cranny and needs constant upkeep. Well, it was nice talking. I assume you'll stop by again sometime. I might be out and about when you do. Don't take it personally. If you don't mind, I was actually hunting. I know you're trying to be nice talking to me, but I've kind of got everything handled here, so you can keep making the rounds. I'm all good. Independent.
Not quite as independent as Charlotte, but Charlotte's more of a brat about it.
I think that's everybody that we can
hypothetically,
talk to.
Yeah.
So, you know, let's go out into the world.
Let's do it.
Now that we've spent an hour customizing our character and meeting everyone. Oh, you know what? There's a little mini map with everyone's faces on it. I didn't notice. Yeah, I think we got everyone.
Oh!
Yeah.
Okay. So... I can click Lavender.
Lavender are added to your collection. Oh! Mouse!
Okay.
Oh. All right. Oh.
All right. So I duck down, and then I press. I am so confused. You know what? Let's see.
There was definitely a tutorial on how to do this that the Cattails YouTube channel put out, and I've forgotten most of it.
I don't click where I want to pounce. I hold down shift and then I push control, which is a little bit hard because I can't use the WASD at the same time as hitting control. So, oh no, is this a, okay. I don't have to use WASD. Okay. I can use the other.
The arrow keys?
Yeah, the arrow keys. I'm doing something wrong.
For the record, an awful lot of people are screaming that we need to go back and get Crampy.
Oh, we lost Crampy. Okay. I'll go back for Crampy just for you. All right, we're gonna see Crampy. I promise. Oh my god, my cat is starving to death.
Oh no.
All right, where is he?
Well, what's a bit of hunger between you and Crampy?
Okay, where's Crampy on the map?
Will any of your kingdom give you food to eat? Is there anyone in your kingdom who can feed you?
I went around talking to people instead of eating food. Do you see where Crampy is?
I have no idea.
They're saying he's, I don't see him on the map. Den, but... This is Garlic's Den.
Garlic's Den.
Okay, so I need to find out what the medicine den is and where it is, so...
Was it down by Phantom? Because Phantom had the herb things.
Maybe.
Or it might not be. I don't know.
That looks like the entrance to the mines. That doesn't look like a medicine den.
That looks more like a temple entrance. Maybe. Maybe.
This is probably Phantom's house. Yeah.
Yeah, this is Phantom's den.
Alright, let's go back down because I
guess you are definitely starving to death. Oh boy.
Can we eat the lavender?
They say check Ember's shop, maybe?
Oh, for food?
Maybe.
This is how you go fast now. Ember, hi.
Oh, also people are spamming log, bottom right of camp.
Okay.
But visit shop for food first.
We don't have any money.
We don't have any money. We can't buy food. Ember, I'm the leader.
What can I get for $4, Ember?
Please give us food. Is there any food that we can get for $4? No. Everything's in the teens.
No.
Okay.
Inflation is killing us.
Come on, Ember.
Alright, so there's a log.
Can you just get us a little discount?
Bottom right, they said?
Bottom right, they say.
Oh, there it is. I see it.
Oh!
Alright, we're gonna meet Crampy. I'm sorry, guys.
I had hypothesized that you would come say hello. Yes, I was off by a few hours, but I'm still refining my method. By the way, I'm a doctor, not a bird. I know the mask can be a bit misleading. My apologies. Surely you already know that about me. I find it helpful to remind everyone from time to time. It is ever so easy to forget. If you're ever badly hurt or in need of a remedy for any malady, I am your cat. Now then, Petunia, what might I be able to do for you? I'm not a dietitian, but I would still recommend that you watch your diet. You appear to be quite hungry at the moment. Yes, thanks, Crampy. We were aware. A balanced and healthy meal would do a lot of good right now. Yeah, also, any food is a good thing to ingest.
You selling those eels, Crampy? Because I'm getting hungry enough, I think.
Those eels will not give you a proper nutritious diet. Maybe you should get something from Ember. Her prices are exceptionally fair.
Okay, I'm about to die of starvation in the wild. Let's see if I can't.
Oh no. Okay, we've learned for next time. Go catch food before you talk to anyone.
Okay, I'm not really sure. I probably should have watched the tutorial because I know that I'm supposed to jump on the prey, but getting lined up to do so. Or maybe I should hit space? Okay, the space. Space pounce, okay. Nope. Sucks to be me. Okay. There we go. Now let's,
eat the food. Before we die.
There we go. And we can also Wahoo! Eat this daisy. Oh, wait, no, we can't.
Oh, that did not actually bring it up that much.
Yeah, but it did prevent me from dying, so let's...
That's true. We aren't dying, which is an improvement.
What's that?
That would be a cat attacking you.
Oh. Will it give me food if I win?
I mean, probably not. Also, you are on very low health, and that will not go well.
Sir,
do you mind? We're trying to not die. We don't need your help.
Trying not to die, and I don't know how to run, so...
It's not shift, is it?
No, shift is crouch, like I'm doing now. I guess the Wildwood does get dangerous at night.
Maybe I should pull up a second video and go watch the tutorial for information.
Well, I know how to hunt now, I swear. I'm just being chased by this guy. Okay, eat a pickup.
Ah! Oh!
Murdered in the prime of my life.
Oh! Your vision flickers out. This can't be the end, can it? You must keep fighting. You hear the muffled sound of a familiar voice calling out. Oh, is it familiar?
Petunia's unfit to lead. Jag should start a coup.
Goodness me! Petunia, you're awake! Excellent. I'm glad you don't actually die. You were looking pretty bad when we found you. Lucky we got to you when you did. But never fear. I have patched up your injuries. A little rest has done you some good, I'll just need to assess you once more before I set you loose. You may have dropped some things when you passed out. I'd be more careful from now on if I were you. We only had one thing, Crampy. I don't think it's that big of a deal. All right, you look fine to me. Stay safe out there, Petunia. I'd hate to see you in that awful state again.
Oh, all of my money.
Oh, thanks. All of your four monies.
Inflation.
Well, we practically live in Disney World here. You can't afford anything.
Okay, well, let's try that again, and this time not get horrifically murdered, maybe.
That would be lovely.
Alright, so shift is to sneak. And space is to pounce.
Maybe like a double press of the button is running then? I don't know. Whee! You caught!
Much easier when you're not. You know, I wonder if that thing that I killed earlier is still out here somewhere.
Marigold added to your collection. Oh, that's a birdie. Oh.
Wait, why am I getting her? Oh, it's because I'm still hungry.
Oh my gosh. Eat the squirrel.
I was like, huh, why am I getting hit? It's because I went outside and I was still starving. Crampy's like, you should get something to eat, but I'm not going to help you with that.
I told you to go to Ember's store, just because you didn't follow my advice.
Crampy finds me in the woods, steals my four meals to get himself a hamburger.
Look, I'm a doctor. All I was prescribed to do is treat your injuries. If you want food, you can get it yourself. You're a capable person. You're the leader, aren't you?
Oh, I'm suffering. That's what I am.
Suffer more!
Oh yeah, that's something a doctor should say. Me and Crampy are about to have problems.
Look, I'm the only reason you're not dead right now.
Also the only reason I have no money.
Okay, that one's not my fault. You died.
the service charge for picking you up and carrying you back.
It happens. A doctor's gotta eat somehow.
Paying for an ambulance over here.
Do you have cat pockets? Is this where you keep your money?
Yeah.
I think you have cat pockets.
I have cat pockets.
I only say because if your money was in your pocket instead of being like carried in your mouth or something, then he would probably have to take it out in order to carry you back without your money.
You think?
I think he took out your money and left it in the forest somewhere.
No, I think he took it and he put it in his little crampy coin purse that's like a copy of himself. Like a tiny crampy.
Well, I didn't want to say anything, but you see, Ember's prices, I mean, I kind of need to buy some stuff sometimes.
Alright, I like this system of attacking a lot more than in the last game, where it was kind of hard to tell what exactly you were supposed to be doing.
A bit, yeah.
Or if you were doing it right, I guess, more so. Looks like the bar changed a little bit there. See, I'm immediately going to just put all of my,
Do you have a chest from the start of the game, or is that something you have to buy?
Oh, I don't know. Let's go look at our den.
Because it might be helpful to store, for instance, food there.
I'm the leader, so I'm the only one allotted a mailbox. Speaking of
which... Oh, your mailbox is flashing. Mailboxes do that. Oh, wow, that's a lot of mail.
Okay.
Hello, Petunia. If you're ever looking for work to do, make sure you stop by the task board in the main town square. Cats use it to post odd jobs that they need doing. If you complete a task, you will surely be rewarded. From Coco.
Howdy, Petunia. It was great to meet you earlier. You seem like a swell cat. Now don't be a stranger. Come and say hi any time you see me out and about. I'll try to do the same. From your neighbor, Bob.
How are you, Petunia? It was so nice to meet you. Thanks for coming by to the shop. If you're ever looking for something in particular, let me know and I'd be happy to help. I'll do my best to provide outstanding service to all my customers for a reasonable price. From Ember.
Hi there, Petunia. Thank you for coming by to introduce yourself. I believe we will work very well together. If you need any medical assistance, for instance, if you die, keep in mind that I'm your cat. I can patch up anything. Almost anything. Someday I'll be able to remove this disclaimer. Hello, Petunia, again. I'm writing because you recently visited the clinic to get a checkup. It was my pleasure to provide you with medical assistance. Please do take care of yourself out there. I'll attach some healing herbs free of charge to help you on your way. You know, in exchange for the money I took, but that's fine.
Crampy sends me a letter every 20 minutes.
Crampy will be sending you a letter every time you get yourself hurt, which I imagine will be rather often.
Alright, so I'm guessing we can just shove things in piles like we did in the old game, but...
Apparently.
Let's see. X to summon Molby. Interesting.
Summon Molby? Oh, we did not assign this one.
I'll do it. Salutations. Is there anything I can do for you today, Petunia? And, please finish your downward evasion view storage.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I can assist with that. Here's your personal storage. Just so you know, you can also access it at any time by interacting with certain furniture items. Alright. You know, we can just put one of everything in here like a normal person. Yeah.
Woohoo!
And, looks like it doesn't count towards the sparrows that I put on the floor.
That's lovely. So once your chest is full, you could just throw prey all around your den, so it's impossible to walk anywhere.
Look at this little jar of fireflies we got.
Oh, that's beautiful!
They're rainbow.
You have a nice little pond in the middle of your den. As you gaze, you see an image of the sky's pier. Today, expect a sunny morning with rain showers beginning in the afternoon. Sorry, I should do a different voice for this one. Today, expect a sunny morning with rain showers beginning in the afternoon and continuing through the night. Right now, there's a light drizzle. Tomorrow, expect clear skies all day long. We have a weather forecasting pond.
We sure do. I am gonna, here, let's see. How do I access my inventory? Alright, like this. Red ladybug, sparrow, magpie. Let's hold the sparrow and let's give it to my friend Jag.
There was no one else you ever would give him the sparrow to?
I think we'd work really well together if we both kept to ourselves. Wow.
I think we'd work well together if we were together.
You really didn't have to, Petunia. Thanks. Okay.
You're still carrying a sparrow, though.
I think it's because I had more than one.
Oh. You can eat one, then.
We can give stuff to Talon, too. We can give
oh boy.
Give things to Talon. God, she just gave me an order. Mind your business. That's an order. Let's see. Huh? What's this for? She does not care for it. A little rain never hurt anyone. There's much worse things that can happen to a cat than getting soaked. Trust me, I'd know. I want to know your thrilling backstory, Talon.
You'll learn it in time.
Let me talk to Jag one more time. It's very normal, but I want to talk to Jag. This is a strange place to call home. I haven't ventured away from town much, but from what I've seen, I don't want to wander too far anyways. Cats could get injured going off in dangerous adventures into the unknown. I agree, let's stay inside all the time and never leave our houses.
What's up, Petunia? Something on your mind? I think I'm sniffing a hint of a snack. Got something to share, Petunia?
They want me to feed them, but they don't want to feed me.
What do you mean? you never asked. I've been wanting one of these for ages! I really owe you one, Petunia. Maybe next time, you know, if you ask for food, I could give it to you. Never mind that you don't have an option to ask for food. It's irrelevant.
I'm never gonna ask anyone for food.
I mean, you're our fearless leader. You can get all the food you want.
Oh, hello. I was just trying to get Lainey to go hunting with me, but I wasn't making much progress on that front. Mother always left the den early and returned late during the springtime. Lots of hunting to do when you have 7 mouths to feed, I suppose.
Oh wait, can I just attack these ladybugs that are floating around in camp?
Oh.
Heh. Not you.
Maybe if you talk to Lainey for her, you can...
convince Lainey to go hunting?
Hopefully.
Hey, I was watching you run around earlier. What do you want to do all day? Most cats get all grumpy when there's the tiniest bit of rain. I don't mind at all. Oh my gosh, you stick your tongue out to get the droplet. I've always liked swimming, and it feels like kind of like that. Plus, as an added bonus, it gets your fur all clean. Aww.
Charlotte said she wouldn't be hanging around here much, but here she is, by her tree yet again.
Hey, what are you looking at? See the spikes? Do they look friendly, approachable, and agreeable? Nah, I'll bet they don't. If you ask me, they look more like, get away, this cat is wild and not in a good mood. I wear them for a reason, you know. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'd like to get back to staring blankly at nothing for a while.
Wow! They are something.
Oh boy. Charlotte is a piece of work.
Sorry if I end up using every single pronoun for these cats. Canonically, I think every single cat in the game is a they, them.
Quite possibly, yeah.
It's easy for me to also just call every cat she. But they are, by canon, anything, I think. If I remember correctly.
Probably?
And in the first game, they didn't have genders, and I think they still don't have genders, so they're all theys. Oh, wait. Oh, what is it now? Did I mess something up again? I don't want to be in trouble. Oh, shoot. Now I have to think of something to talk about. It's not nice to put so much social pressure on someone else. I was already in a bad mood, and now I feel even worse. I don't blame you for not noticing, though. I'm always frowning. Let's see if there's anything. Let's see.
Give them a daisy.
What? What are you up to, Petunia? That's mean, and you know it. Oh my god, I just made garlic hate me.
Oh.
Every time I see you walking around, it makes me sad. I've started trying to avoid you, but apparently I can't even do that right. Alright, so, we need to make this better. We need to find something garlic likes. I'm gonna bet on food.
Well, by happenstance, because we were thinking of who to voice, I do have all of his likes and dislikes up. He likes, they like, she likes, sir likes, turtles, thistles, and sleeping in. Can you give them thistle? Is that a thing you can find?
Let's look for thistles then. Let's look for... Oops. Sucks to be me. Okay, let's look for some thistles. Oh, am I running? I'm running.
How did you do it?
No clue. I made garlic hate me by giving garlic a flower.
I'm sorry, garlic. I didn't know.
They're like, I hate you. I never want to see you again. Oh, and they were already upset.
Get them something good. Something spiky. Actually, maybe Charlotte would like a spiky thing too, but you don't need to get in with them.
in, not in Cattails, but in Warrior Cats, the Warrior Cats fan game, you could scratch trees to get things out of them. What was that?
Oh.
I have no idea. Maybe those are thistles. Oh my god!
Oh, that's a squirrel! You caught a squirrel.
I guess I did.
Was that what you meant? Oh boy, it's what you've got now!
That wasn't what I was trying for at all. Okay. Oh, there's a fish over there.
Oh, that was perfect. Wow.
Got it. There's also a very strange-looking fish up here.
Yeah, that's unlike any fish I've ever seen.
Yeah, no wonder I couldn't catch it. Catnip. Oh wait, all the cats like catnip in the last game, I think. So let's give Garlic the catnip, because I think...
Yeah, let's do it.
I think that'll work.
I really hope they don't also hate catnip.
I double hate you, Petunia. I never want to see you again.
Catnip? What the heck? You know this is my least favorite thing in the world.
I can hold a lot of stuff. The last game, I don't think I could hold a terrible amount of stuff. Valerian. That was in the last game too, wasn't it? What?
Oh, shoot. Oh, boy. Oh, there's battle music.
How do I run? Double tapping. There we go.
Oh, okay. That was my second guess.
Let's run up to Garlic and see if we can't make this right.
When does Garlic go to bed?
Nobody goes to bed.
It's 1 in the morning.
That's for me. Thanks. And okay. They like us a normal amount again.
Good. Okay.
Oh, you look kind of beat up. I know how that feels, you get used to it. I'm gonna, eat.
Eat food.
And I'm gonna...
Is this like Minecraft? Do you only start, regaining health if you're at full hunger?
I don't know if you regain health. I have no idea.
Oh!
I just use golden seal on myself, though.
Oh, right, you have herbs!
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, I was being silly there.
Wolfcat in the chat says the cat is a bag of holding. Alright, let's explore in the other direction a little, I guess.
Sure.
Ooh, a strawberry. That's a Ooh. Thing a cat doesn't eat. Oh, it's a raspberry, never mind. Also a thing a cat doesn't eat, but...
Let's go look up if anyone likes raspberries.
It's up to us. We gotta start the Cattails Wildwood story wiki ourselves. Garlic hates daisies.
Okay. I can't find anyone from the original profiles that likes raspberries, but it's entirely possible that someone has a hankering for raspberries.
So, in the last game, there were skills. Have you seen any indication as to those skills here?
I feel like I saw that in one of the tutorials, and also I don't remember.
Yeah, I watched them, I just, I don't remember. Yeah, imagine being a frog. Birch Lake.
Birch Lake?
I guess.
Oh, the birch trees are pretty.
There's birch trees everywhere. Imagine being a frog.
Imagine being a frog. Goldenrod, maybe? Oh, no, never mind. I'm entirely wrong.
Marigold.
Marigold.
Two stars. Yeah, I'm not happy with that frog. Oh, catching fish is so much easier. In the first game, I'm pretty sure some of the creatures that I just never caught were fish.
I really like the music. Entirely off topic, I just really like the music.
You can't sneak while swimming. This ecosystem's getting destroyed.
Don't worry, this is a magically replenishing ecosystem that just forms prey out of the ether whenever you need it. This the Fallen Temple or something? That looks like a very interesting rock. Let's kill it! Kids, when you go up to national monuments, make sure to take a hammer and smash them.
My paws are not hammers, they are gentle.
Sorry, make sure to take a knife and slash them.
Okay. First mouse I've seen?
I think you saw one originally, but you missed it. That was one of your, like, first hunting sessions.
You know what? I think a memory is coming back to me. I think I might need to sleep to get experience.
Oh!
This could be nonsense.
You have not done that yet. It has been 2.5 days. That was thistle! It said thistle added to your collection.
Oh boy! We can give that to garlic. Maybe, exactly. maybe Petunia likes garlic. Even though garlic is, miserable.
Well, it doesn't even have to necessarily be that Petunia likes garlic, but Petunia doesn't want to get on garlic's bad side either. Make it up to them, you know?
Let me check the map here. Alright, so we are as far from home as we possibly
can. As we can possibly get. Okay.
This seems to be the world map for the demo specifically, which would explain why it's, it's not taking up this whole space, but... Okay, let's make our way back home, I suppose. You cannot, run in water either.
Someone said that, Petunia looks like my design with your color palette.
It's our baby.
It is! We didn't intend them to be, but, you know, this is our baby. This is Petunia. We birthed him.
There might be some turtles around here.
Did you already check the red berry thingamajigs?
Oh. No.
You got a scallop! Are there scallops in the... I'm sending you in 80 different directions at once.
We've got raspberries. Is that what you meant?
Those... Oh, no. The things, like, on the bushes with the red berries, maybe.
Okay, were they over here? this.
And also to the right, but yeah, those ones.
I guess they're just a plant.
Okay.
But we can get this.
Ah!
And we can get this. I'm glad I learned how to run. Even though I do run a bit like a horse, don't I?
Running is helpful.
Oh, here's a shell.
Oh, that's lovely.
Getting a bit better about my
You are. You are significantly better than you were, an hour or so ago?
Look at that!
Very nice! Shoot!
See, as much as I love Jag, it might be fun to
romance someone else.
Attempt to romance someone else a little. See where it goes.
Is Jag romanceable?
Yes, all of them are. Every single one.
Oh!
So what do you have any preference, Sunny?
I have negative preference.
You don't have a
I like all the kitties. And I would be happy to see the path of any of them.
No, you don't like fluffy kitties better than calico kitties?
Well, okay, let's be honest. Design-wise, Eli is my favorite. But...
You don't have to actually be attracted to cats. I don't think
anyone
is.
Well, yeah. But I haven't known them long enough to have an absolute favorite. This will probably come in a couple of hours. It will speak to me. I will suddenly get a vision in my mind that, ah yes, this is your favorite cat. You should try to marry them.
Oops, this crab's gonna kill me now.
Ah. Oh boy, oh,
wait,
oh boy.
No, the crab's running from me.
Yeah, crab is trying to attack you just very badly. Crab's getting stuck behind a tree. This is very advantageous for us.
That was a that was a planned assault.
This is exactly what we meant to do. People are now suggesting various people that we should romance.
Oh yeah, what does the chat think?
Buttercup, Garlic, Charlotte, Garlic, Buttercup, Garlic or Charlotte, Crab. Okay, I don't think that was supposed to be a romanceable option.
Crab doesn't like us very much, guys. Neither does Snake.
Don't romance the crab. Please don't romance the crab.
Crab and Snake both hate our guts.
Oh, Ember. Crampy, Garlic,
I think
Charlotte,
that's one
Ember.
One person saying Ember.
Yeah. Well, there's two people saying Ember. Three.
Alright.
Well, oh boy. I'm accidentally flooding the chat.
Okay.
Sorry.
I do think the one I've seen the most is Garlic from the most different people.
Yeah, yeah. We have already had the most starter of a relationship with them, so it would make sense.
Yeah, we've had conversations with Garlic. Let's see how
we've had an unfortunate interaction and a makeup.
Well, Garlic is still white, so let's go to sleep and
that's a good idea.
Assuming we can at this time of day. I mean, we are a cat.
We are a cat. We should be able to sleep whenever we want. This looks like a great spot to curl up and sleep for a while. What would you like to do?
Bedtime. Here we go. Look at that.
Okay, we're done now.
All right. So that did not
get It is midnight.
Yeah.
Oh boy. Okay.
We know people who wake up at midnight.
We do. Yes, we do.
Let's see here. garlic. Oh, what is it now? Did I mess something up again? This is the same thing that they said last time. Let's chat. You probably don't want to hang around me too long. I've been told I bring the energy down. I'm sure it's all true. Not that your energy is much better. I can feel your disapproval. No need to verbalize it. I already know all about it. Alright, so garlic thinks that they suck. Let's look for the thistles in our inventory. Licorice, raspberry.
There we go. There, yeah.
Yes, okay. That's for me. Thanks. That's all they had to say.
Can you give them another thistle?
Let's see. Oh no, please put it away. My paws are full and I'm sure I'll lose it if I take it.
Okay, we'll need to wait until tomorrow, but we just need to continuously shove thistles in their face, and this will be great.
Yeah. Let's sell some bugs to Ember. I'm sure that's normal.
Hello, Petunia. Out running errands? Oh, you don't want to listen to me. That's fine.
We can.
Oh, no, I didn't actually need you to... If shopping is on your list, I can help with that.
Alright, let's see here. Would you like some delicious bugs? Oh, wow. I've got 9 red lady... We can just cash in these ladybugs.
Sell those bugs! Oh, but they're all just 1 mew. Okay. That makes sense.
The marigold is worth quite a bit, as it turns out.
It is.
Well, we have 5 of them, so actually it's worth 3, as it turns out. Let's see. These shells are worth 5. What are you selling, Ember, now that I have a small amount of money?
You clicked sell again.
Oops. I would have been like, huh, why does she have everything I have?
Butterflies and roses and engagement trinkets.
Oh, wow. A divorce flower. I love divorcing.
Oh, no! An ugly, wilted flower that nobody likes to see. Give it to a cat to end your relationship. Oh, no.
You walk up. You walk up to your husband. Guys, don't spam no garlic.
Don't spam date garlic no garlic. Don't spam in general.
We'll get closer to garlic. We'll see how we feel. How about that, guys?
If garlic becomes interesting as we're getting to know them, we might consider it, or we might not. We'll see.
I love the divorce flower.
Divorce flower.
Oh, God, imagine you're the guy who grows divorce flowers. If your entire living is cultivating divorce flowers.
These are the flowers that no one wants. No one wants my flowers. They buy them specifically to give them to cats who they'd like to break it off with. What is my life worth?
So a lot of these are decorations, songs... Yeah. Ooh.
You could apparently buy a jar of leeches, which I can only imagine is exceptionally helpful.
Hold on. It says items will now stack up to a maximum of 5 of in each of your inventory slots. Does that mean we had multiple inventory slots filled with ladybugs before?
I believe so, yes.
I'm guessing 3 is the maximum, because we've got 3 trout here, 1 trout here.
That seems to be the case, yes.
In the last game, Jag liked fireflies. I don't know what Jag likes now. Sorry, not to float over towards Jag again. We're all
No, off you go. Float towards Jag at your leisure.
Rabbit Jag. Let's see. This is too good a gift for Jag. You really shouldn't have. Thanks, Petunia.
Does Jag talk in the third person sometimes?
I hope so. That's wonderful. I barely remember. He's my favorite character, and I don't... I'm not afraid of the rain. It's a free bath, essentially. Won't stop me from carrying out my duties.
You know, I think you should talk to Lainey. They have a similar opinion.
Yeah. Maybe if I had less discipline, I'd retreat into my den and wait it out like some cats. I could never betray my kingdom like that.
I actually am beginning to seriously appreciate that we called it a kingdom. Mm-hmm. It makes it sound so much more majestic when you leave out the actual name of the kingdom.
The grass-eating kingdom.
Grass-eating kingdom!
We love eating grass, that's why we're outside.
Exactly.
Mind your own business. That's an order. I'm tired, but I've got some time left in my watch before I turn in. Protecting the kingdom is an honor and a privilege. Wow. She, likes protecting the kingdom even though I'm the leader and hates me.
Hey, I was watching you run around earlier. What do you do all day? It's so dark out. How can you even see anything? I keep stumbling on tree roots. I think I hit my paw pretty bad.
They look legitimately concerned about the dark here.
Maybe you could give them an herb for their poor hurt paw or something. Oh. Save them the trips to Sparks.
I'm sorry, the chat mentioned the divorce flower again. Now I'm just thinking of the divorce flower.
I've also accidentally started the date the crab trend. We're not dating the crab. Under no circumstance are we dating the crab.
Hey, what are you looking at? Hey, do you scare easily? Some cats get real skittish at night. I don't know what it is. Maybe the moon and the shadows are doing something sinister. If so, watch your back.
I can tell you, the moon is always doing something sinister.
Wow! You can say that, Sunny. Let's give a crab to Charlotte. Let's see how Charlotte feels about crab. Because Charlotte seems crabby.
Okay, if you're sure you want me to have it, I'll take it.
I don't really know how to gauge that response from her.
Who's to send you, really? Leave me alone is the general premise here.
I sold all my bugs. I don't know what Crampy likes, but let's give something to Crampy for fun. Maybe a plant? Like licorice? Or, well, marigold is a health thing, so let's pick up a marigold.
Oh, sorry, I completely forgot.
Good day to you. Are you in need of my services? If you have the time, I have many experiments to carry out today. Now, where did I put that jar of leeches? By my beak, that's an amazing specimen! I would be delighted to welcome you into my personal quarters, Petunia. It is a great honor to sit in one's home with the leader of the grass-eating kingdom and chat for a spell. There is no way you can say that. That doesn't sound sarcastic.
I'm sorry. Have you considered that maybe some of these cats do appreciate being part of the wonderful and noble grass-eating
kingdom? No, it's entirely possible. This is a noble breed to have come into.
They are, Oh no. There is stuff going on back here. Crampy, how did you even put this together? This is a chemistry set.
I have my ways.
Yeah, I'm sure I could expect some mail about it later. So the Kickstarter for this game is, it's already fully funded. So it's definitely
four times over, I think.
Yeah. And what's the cool thing that they, the current, goal that they're at right now is that if they get 150k, they are going to, they're going to allow, like, rival marriages. And I'm really curious to see where that goes.
As far as I can tell, that would mean, like, if you don't romance someone quick enough, they will start getting married to each other and even having kittens that way.
Maybe. I think I read when he was talking that he planned for Falcon being he. Planned for them to ask you if it was okay that they got married so that you don't miss out on what you like. Not like
that would
In older Harvest Moon games, they could get married, specifically Friends of Mineral Town, I remember. As the game progressed and you weren't close enough with people, they would definitely just start getting together with other characters. And there were definitely ways around it, like if you were playing as a boy, because you could deny Cliff a job and then he's no longer a love rival for Anne, and you could just never visit the beach in summer, and that way you don't have to say hi. In the girl,
or you could not sabotage people's lives and relationships.
It's very normal in a Harvest Moon game to sabotage people's lives and relationships, but in the girl version of the game, you didn't really get that leniency. I didn't have a trick for my character that Mary was the librarian girl, and I was always going for her in the boy version, and I hated Gray, and the problem was I wasn't very good at the game because I was a kid, so I didn't really understand, like, the kind of tactics, like, the kind of, terrible tactics that you have to use to, get these girls to like you. Like following them around and giving them like 3 gifts a day and whatnot, and so I wasn't very good at it. So this every time I played the game, Gray stole my wife.
Oh!
So I just hated him, and this is not safe.
This that is lava. Safe. Don't. Is,
so bird.
Don't step in the lava.
Bird.
If the bird goes in the lava, don't jump after the bird.
Well, the bird is in the lava. Why can't the lava. I go in the lava? This isn't fair.
The bird flies over the lava. You cannot fly. Petunia, you are weak and fragile.
All Petunia wants is a little dip in the lava, and the world denies this.
Petunia, you have soft, fragile body. You will get burned. Don't get burned. Don't go in lava.
Sorry, I'm trying to, hold on a second. Collections, social. None of these are my stats. But, this is interesting. It lets you know if you've talked to someone and if you've given them a gift.
That is very helpful, actually. Mm-hmm. I really love Eli. On design alone, I just... It's such a beautiful design, you know, with the orange on one side, the brown on the other, the white up the middle.
Yeah,
it's a very attractive design.
I wonder what kind of cat might have an orangish design with some brown on one side. And
I mean, a pretty great one, it'd have white, to be.
White in the middle of okay. Alright, so does not show us our stats. The inventory doesn't. But wait, hold on. Let's go back to that again. What button was that? Q? Yes. We do have something up here in the corner, being covered up by Sunny, actually.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I moved you. that's our money, our job points, and maybe that's experience, that third thing?
Potentially? All right, that would be my guess.
Putting Sunny back on top of it. But, let's see.
I shall cover your resources. I shall keep them safe.
That's the map. Hunger, health. What? Alright. I get it, you're mean. You get out of here.
Kill crab. Kill crab. Dead crab.
I'm just trying to date you, crab. It's not so bad.
Really? Are you willing to date any crab?
Yeah, I don't have a preference.
Typical.
Alright, let's, Alright, Marigold treats poison. I guess I know Golden Seal helps with health, but I don't think I have any. Alright, let's,
Is Thistle edible? What does Thistle do?
Thistle improves your swimming for a short
swimming
time.
Swimming for a short time. Interesting.
I wonder if Garlic likes to swim.
Potentially. Who's to say?
Oh, no lizard for me. But yes on mouse.
Very nice.
Do you see any turtle?
Turtle, turtle, turtle. That looks like a frog.
Yeah, imagine being a frog.
Perfect! Wow!
Okay, let's see. Turtle, turtle. Delicious turtle.
Shell.
Oh, there's another shell. I wonder how much Crampy charges. Oh, there's a golden seal, never mind. Your inventory is full.
Oh no!
And it's full of trash. Alright, let's put some of these ladybugs down and golden. I'm very good at dropping things. Okay. Q. Golden seal. Use. Golden seal. Use. Alright, and let's,
It has been used. You are healed.
I guess we can go sell some of these, Ugh.
Bad mean cats. No bad mean cat.
There's golden seal right there.
Oh.
Crab!
Look, sir, I'm sorry. We didn't mean to break up with you. It's just...
Oh my god. Okay. Stuff to sell. She looks so proud carrying the mouse like this.
She's made a lovely catch.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you to talk to me. I usually just keep to myself. Not that I don't like company or anything, I just tend to keep to myself. Thank you. Honestly, I could have gotten this myself, but I appreciate the gesture. Do you like to hunt, Petunia? I find it very fun. Plus, you end up with a nice meal when you're all finished. What better way could there possibly be to spend the day? Really likes hunting.
Really, really likes hunting.
Really likes to kill.
Hello, Petunia. Out running errands? If shopping is on your list, I can help with that.
To sell to you.
That's lovely. I would be happy to give you a modest sum of these.
Oh, she'll just... if there's only one thing...
Valerian, I can take that off your paws for 2 mews. What do you say?
No thanks.
Since we know daisies are very bad now.
Yep. Give somebody a daisy, they hate you for life. Conscious worth 25. You're gonna be loaded selling all these shells. Maybe we can even buy a divorce flower.
Why would we even need a divorce flower? No one likes us enough for that to be worth it.
Sometimes you just need to get rid of people.
Did the voice flower go to Charlotte?
I don't know. Alright.
Who do you want to cut from your life forever?
Alright, yesterday was Bob's birthday. I didn't even know.
Oh no.
Tomorrow is Coco's birthday.
Coco's birthday!
Oh, that's our storage. Okay. One of everything, I think. Yeah, just shove things in the box. Okay. I'm gonna try sleeping again. See if maybe I have enough experience to, No, I get experience from doing that, but I'm gonna try pushing all the buttons on my keyboard.
That is, usually a great thing to do in games.
Alright, that's the summon Wolby button. You know what? Actually, here. Options. Bind controls, keyboard. You know what? Maybe there's someone I need to talk to make myself
better. Potentially, yeah.
Maybe this board
will look to me. Yeah.
Coming soon. Okay, so there's nothing to do on the board.
The rain doesn't really bother me. Lainey and I learned to swim at a very young age. Mother said it would help us to stop freaking out about getting our fur wet. Seems like it worked.
Alright, fine. I will use the dead crab as decoration in my den. If you stop spamming, use the dead crab as the decoration in your den. But this will not work for anything else you spam.
Some things are just so special, you need to display them so you can see them every day. The crab is upside down.
Yeah, I'm fixing it.
Okay.
Looks like upside down might be the only way the crab comes in, but let's...
Oh. Crab, don't you want to be right side up? Don't you, though?
Nope, it turns upside down. There you go. Dead crab in my den. By the pool. So it can drink. Even though it's dead.
Dead things can still drink. Do you want to discriminate against who can drink or not?
Yes.
Aww.
Oh wait, I forgot to sell some of these bugs. And I keep forgetting I can run. Okay, and I want to keep most of the food just in case I die.
Yeah, good idea, General.
Still white. Let's see what's up here.
Oh, the festival plaza.
I guess it's not time for a festival yet. Hmm. It's nice and so close to home now, though. In the last game, you had to travel quite a ways.
I don't technically know what the map will be like in the final release, but as far as this goes, it's very nice.
Yeah, I'm guessing... I'm not sure, but there are quite a few cats in my camp already in this demo version,
yeah.
It's a little dangerous going out at night in this game because the cats get after you.
Cats just start attacking you for no reason.
I think the reason might be because they're rude.
You mean for no reason? Rudeness is not a proper reason for anything. Perfect!
Kind of fun just to hunt now that it's a quick time event as opposed to a random one.
And you certainly seem to have gotten the handle on it.
You say that, but I just killed a bird. Oh, I need food.
Yum yum squirrel.
See, I think if you're close when you start the pounce,
you have a better chance.
Yeah, and that perfect thing I think comes up.
Yeah. Oh, I think the perfect thing was. Okay, don't quote me on this because it's been a while and I have forgotten most of it. But I think there's some sort of thing to do with the circles when you're entering it. That if it falls on the proper amount of circle, then you'll get the chance to do a perfect attack, and that's when you get the teal bars.
I think that's, yeah, this. See?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh no. Don't see any turtles, though. Well, there's a question mark on my screen. Looks like it's that toad. No. Okay. Maybe I don't want to fight you. Maybe I'm done fighting. Huh? You ever think of that?
It's been so long. We just need to let it go.
Every time we see each other, it's just a fight now, me and the crab.
I know. You know, I don't want to have to say this, but I think you need to leave them. I don't think this is a good relationship. I don't think either of you are getting anything good out of it.
Me and Crab.
You and Crab. Petunia and Crab.
Yeah. Maybe turtles are from a different season. Oh.
Potentially, yeah. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. It's dead crab. Okay. Oh, that was the easiest hunt of all time. I believe this is what we in the business call a panic attack.
Well, don't make me feel bad about killing. Oh my god, the lava is reflective of the stars.
Every life you steal here, it's a life that will never continue forward. That is a lot of lava.
It's so tempting.
Don't you dare That's bad ouchy liquid. Don't enter the bad ouchy liquid.
Petunia knows what she's doing. It's going in the lava. What is this? As it turns out, I have no idea what that was.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I got it. Lots of fun places to go here.
Many, many fun lavas to jump into.
Yeah.
Oh, there... I will admit, I did not expect to find prey here. Maybe not the smartest prey.
Never underestimate your enemies, honey. There we go, a lizard. And some nice, fun shadow cats.
Oh.
I flew too close to the sun.
That'll kill you.
Unfortunately, you can't, in the last game, you could just kind of corner things as they run up and down walls and whatnot and just attack them like that. It was like 90% of my hunting strategy. Where am I? Oh, very far away. I should.
The stream from my end and not from the chat's end will fade out into less quality whenever you change a map.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Alright, so I can't go up here, probably, according to the map. But I'm gonna try anyway.
Maybe there's something interesting. You don't know. There are lots of pretty flowers.
There's Bunny.
Bunny! Oh, wow, that's a... Oh, wow! Okay.
Oh, it was hair. Right, and I can't go any further up.
That's big, yeah. I should hope that sells for at least as much as it takes to buy a hair.
I don't think it'll be as much as it takes to buy a hair. Then we could start probably some money laundering schemes with Ember, you know?
It would be a very bad business practice to actually sell it for as much as it takes to buy a hair.
Do you remember what the thistle looked like?
Not in its plant form. I just remember noticing that you got it. Fish gone.
The brain didn't work there. There's Daisy, our natural enemy. Daisy from Warrior Cats.
Oh. But I like Daisy, though.
Daisy from Warrior Cats did nothing wrong.
Daisy from Warrior Cats is a delight.
This is fun. It's cute. It's fun. I like the original Cattails a lot. It's nice to actually get to play something like this.
It's the sort of game I could see myself losing a few hours in and just enjoying myself.
My front paw has been hurting all morning. I think I slept on it wrong. You'd think I'd have figured out how to sleep properly by now. I do it all the time, but no. I'm not that smart, I guess. Oh, self-deprecating cat. What
do we have? I do seem like a very strong pessimist.
You don't want to hang on to it? Okay, I guess. I can't think of anything to do with it, though. You eat it! You eat it!
Eat food! We learned that on our first day here. Now we're passing this lesson on to you, Garlic.
Flavorful. I don't remember the voices I gave to most of these cats.
To what do I owe the pleasure of your esteemed presence? Shh! I must talk no longer! I am receiving a message from beyond and I must not miss it!
I love that sprite. Someone in the chat seems to have started up a lava laundering business. Don't drink the bad ouchy liquid!
Oh, but I just love to,
have
a little sip, you know?
Little sip not good for you! You may think you want it, but you don't, though, is the thing.
So, how much for some lava, huh, chat?
Actually, lava should be at an infinite price. You should not be buying lava.
Delicious.
Hello, Petunia. Did you come by to wish me a happy birthday? It's funny how a birthday just feels like any other day. I still have so much to do before I can relax for a bit and celebrate.
Alright, what's a very default thing we can give to Coco? Because Coco is a default kind of guy. Vol?
They are, yeah. Vol is a default thing. You can give them the Vol that just scurried around in a panic and then got caught. Hello, Petunia. Did you come by to wish me a happy birthday? Oh, this Vol makes for a nice gift. Thank you, Petunia. You're a sweetie.
Is she, though? Still only one star. So I do wonder how many points it takes. Let's look at our...
Big Sunnyfall is absolutely content with holding you back from the lava soup business. Lava soup business, no good for you. No good lava soup.
Big Sunnyfall.
Big Sunnyfall stops you from all the fun stuff.
Yeah, one star with everybody, but when we dropped below one star for Garlic, it came right back up after giving them the...
Yeah.
The plan.
It's possible that negative relationships are healed more quickly.
Mind your own business. That's an order. Colonies aren't built and maintained by having casual conversations. There's work that needs doing. Now, if you'll excuse me. Free golden seal for me. And free other stuff. Free scallop on the ground. I just love having things in my inventory.
Things in your inventory are comforting.
Let's see here.
Fishy.
Ah.
Oh.
No fish for me.
Well, there's one other fish down there.
Unless. Nope.
No fishy.
No fish for me.
No fishy for you.
So, how exactly do you guys make lava popsicles? Just give me a play-by-play
process. I am admittedly curious about that too.
Are they freeze-dried?
I'm not sure that works with lava, is the thing. See, when lava cools past a certain point, it it stops being lava. It becomes rock, actually, is the thing, though.
Sure, it doesn't become fire. I think fire might be a... I'm sorry, I shouldn't get science wrong on purpose on stream. That's probably... probably a bad influence kind of thing to do.
All of those lovely outer sections of island, around volcanic islands at least, are made from cooled lava, which is not a good popsicle. If you'd like that as a popsicle, feel free to go to Hawaii and lick the ground. I don't recommend it. And for the record, math in my brain is black because it was my most recent colored folder for that, but math has been the constantly changing one. Do you have any opinions on school subject colors?
Mine were all standardized.
Oh, really?
In both schools I went to, and they happened to be the same in both schools I went to, so...
Strong associations, then.
Yeah. So when I say things, you have to know that I'm correct.
Of course, yes. Well, I mean, that's just true in general.
So, social studies is red.
Oh, yeah, but you're wrong, though.
Yeah, science is yellow.
Yeah. Oh, that's worse.
Math is blue.
No.
Yeah, see, you're immediately hurt by the things I have to say.
It's not hurt, it's just that English is blue. ELA.
English is purple.
No. And see, science is green. That's just a universal truth. Everyone can agree on that. See, social studies is usually yellow.
Social studies is yellow. That just...
Yeah.
But wouldn't you think of history and go, that's a very red thing?
No, I think of it as rather blank and neutral and full of hope and possibility or death and destruction.
Like red?
No, that's not red. Red is just instant death and destruction. Hmm. Here and now. That's foreign language. Foreign language is red.
Foreign language yeah. Is of having a color. I don't even think I had a folder for that one.
Spanish, French, Chinese, whatever language you're taking, it's red.
Let's talk to Buttercup. She probably wouldn't want to talk to us.
Oh, are you talking to me? Sorry, I startle easily. Oh, are you sure about that? But I don't really know what to talk about. Sorry, Petunia.
We need to feed her.
Yeah, feed Petunia.
How kind of you. Thank you.
All she had to
they
say.
Didn't say thank you, but, you know,
well,
we're adding
she
that.
She implied thank you.
The thank you was there. The thank you was in her eyes.
I forgot what I was doing. Oh yeah, I was selling all my garbage to Ember.
Right, yes.
But not the thistle, that's for our friend. Oh, Q to sell everything? Oh, not everything I'm holding, no.
Oh, goodness, no. But hypothetically, you could put everything you want to keep in your chest one day and come back with a big lot to sell and do it much quicker, which could be convenient.
Yes.
Every time we speak to Buttercup, there's a flood of comments that say Buttercup is cute. I would like to say, yes, you're correct, Buttercup is adorable.
Poor Buttercup.
Buttercup baby.
Alright, there's something I want out of the shop. The most important possible thing, a backpack expansion.
Oh, yes. I appreciate your business.
Your inventory has been upgraded, which probably wasn't a line, but haha.
So now we can hold 5 of everything. Unfortunately, the different types of plants stack separately from each other.
Yeah.
Nothing new in our mailbox. Looks like Crampy is holding off.
You haven't come to speak with Crampy.
Well, we can come speak to Crampy. Here we go.
Good day to you. Are you in need of my services? If you have the time, I have many experiments to carry out today. Now, where did I put that jar of leeches? While I am accustomed to seeing many cats in the clinic, I don't often have visitors in my living quarters. Perhaps you can help me track down a leech I lost yesterday. He slithered out of his jar on the shelf and plopped right on the floor. Surely he is still lurking about in my bedroom somewhere.
Every time we see him, he's just way too excited that we're in his house.
Why do you think that's odd? Of course I'm excited to have you. Yeah. I think I've got an empty spot on my shelf for this.
Okay. Look at the leeches. I love the leeches.
One of the leeches is lost. Do you want to look for a leech? No, you don't. This is fine.
Our cat is cute. I'm just putting that out there.
Oh, yeah, no. Petunia is adorable.
Jack.
I think we'd work really well together if we both kept to ourselves, as he said the last 3 times we talked to him.
He said this last time, too. Okay. Oh, wait, no.
Maybe if I had less discipline, I'd retreat to my den and wait it out like some cats. I could never betray my kingdom like that.
Alright, let's, something for Jag.
You don't need this for anything? Well, I guess I'll take it.
What do you think Talon likes?
Well, there's a difference between what I think and what I can easily see by reading this. They like snakes, honeycomb, and strategy. They dislike raspberries and wasting time.
Let's see if they like crab.
This is outrageous! Do you know who you're dealing with?
Okay, they hate crab.
They don't like crab. Don't give crab. Bad
crab. Do they hate us now?
Oh boy.
Okay, they don't. But, you know.
So, Talon, no crab. No crab. No crab.
Wants got nothing it. Okay, cool. to do with the crab, but wants something to do with snake. So let's keep that in mind next time we see snake.
Have you ever seen snake?
I have. It attacked me once.
Oh, lovely.
Remember we were actually around this area and the snake just clobbered us.
No, you're absolutely right. That is coming to memory now.
Oh, there's some friends.
Oh, those look like great friends.
Wow, you
I've noticed that our friends have speckles coming off their back.
Yeah, little sparkly sparkles.
Those must be the sparkles of friendship.
Come back, come back. Are you running from me? Oh.
Oh, goodness.
Void Morrow? Do I have pieces of this thing's body in my inventory? A writhing pile of shadowy essence. It gives you an uneasy feeling.
Oh, no.
You know, it already gave me an uneasy feeling before I picked it up, to be honest with you.
Oh, boy.
What is that?
Our great friend's residue is not great.
I love having the residue of my friends in my inventory.
Yeah, that's a great feeling. I love having residue of friends in
my
inventory.
It's like being able to smell people on their clothes.
That's a lovely visual, thank you.
Don't worry, I'll always remember you by the residue in my inventory.
Oh no! I think that is how I will say goodbye to everyone from now on.
What, when they die? No,
just if we're leaving for a long period of time. If you're going on a vacation, or if it's the end of a school semester or something.
A little bit problematic, but I think we can go with it.
No running away, Crab. Good boy.
Even though Crab is not a good gift.
No, Crab bad.
Crab has been neutral.
Talon doesn't like Crab any more than we do anymore. I bet Crab had a really bad breakup with Talon.
We got a flower called Queen of the Night.
Oh, that sounds amazing. Let's give that to Charlotte.
Wonder if Charlotte likes flowers.
Well, they like snake, lily, and amethyst. So, hypothetically, they might like flowers that aren't snake lilies. My assumption is that if a flower is edgy enough, they'll appreciate it.
Yeah, and that one is called Queen of the Night.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if you can get any more edgy than that.
I understand we're neglecting half of the cast here, like Champ, who wants to overthrow us and become the leader himself, but, you know, we can talk to Bob. Well, now, how you doing, Petunia? I would enjoy a friendly chat today. You don't look so good. You gotta relax. Being the leader must be taking a toll on you. Oh, I guess I look a little funny, huh? Where's my golden seal? Now I'm normal. Charlotte. Swoosha in the chat.
Sorry, yes.
Swoosha in the chat says, Champ is my favorite. God knows why.
Hey, what are you looking at? Oh, I'm surprised you saw me. I was trying to blend in with the scenery. My dark fur makes it easier for me to hide. Meanwhile, my blindingly white collar is not quite as helpful. If I really wanted to be stealthy, If I really wanted to be stealthy, I should take this collar off. The contrast is what gave me away, I assume. But it's too fashionable to leave behind, so I'd rather keep it on.
She's making a statement.
It's needed sometimes.
Okay, let's give this weird thing to Charlotte.
Oh, neat. I actually really like these, Petunia. That's sweet of you.
Wow. You were right. Right on the money with what Charlotte likes.
I am very good at reading Charlotte.
It's like, okay, so it's still a flower, but it's gotta be a dark, brooding, and mysterious flower.
It has to be an edgy flower. Dark, brooding, mysterious, blood-coated flowers.
I bet you Charlotte looks up things like goth anime girl on Google Images to find profile pictures.
This obviously isn't a feature of the game, but I wonder if Charlotte would appreciate rose stems. It's taking away the facade of beauty and just appreciating the real reality of the spike. What in the world are you fighting?
Snake.
Is that a cat?
It's snake.
Is that prey? Oh, that's a snake! Get a snake! Give to Charlotte. Oh, no!
Murdered. Oh, and all of my stuff is probably going to be taken by Crampy now.
Yeah. No. Crampy, don't go stealing our stuff!
Goodness me, Petunia, you're awake. Excellent. You were looking pretty bad when we found you. Lucky we got to you when we did. But never fear, I have patched up your injuries. A little rest has done you some good, I'll just need to assess you once more before I set you loose. You may have dropped some things when you passed out. I'd be more careful for you from now on if I were you. All right, you look fine to me. Stay safe out there, Petunia. I'd hate to see you in that awful state a third time.
Oh my gosh, look at all the things that Crampy just took from our inventory.
Crampy, this is not the way to get things. Go out and hunt yourself.
Crampy is operating a business over here.
Really?
What does my inventory look like right now? Oh, it's mostly crap.
You run a tighter ship than Ember, and that's impressive.
Crampy, you didn't even want the Void Marl? Come on. You didn't want the weird Crampy. Crap?
It's my birthday. Which one, you ask? Well, I stopped counting a long time ago. Life is simpler that way. I am taking the entire day to test my new theory. It's a gift to myself. You are helping with the field research portion because it involves you, of course.
Concerned.
Now, if you could stand still as possible for the next 5 minutes. Yes, sir. It's just as I expected. How exciting!
But we don't have anything to give you as a gift, Crampy, because you took everything!
Give him a gift anyway.
It's my birthday! Thank you for already giving me most of your stuff, but I'll take the gift as well. Well, what a well-considered present, Petunia! You have made this day the happiest of birthdays!
Oh, Crampy.
Crampy. It's not nice to steal from people, Crampy.
Crampy could just leave us in the woods, though.
I mean, sure. But alternatively, he could also bring us back and not take stuff from us.
Wait, did Crampy take our thistle? Oh, no, he didn't. Okay.
No. Yes, okay. I mean,
I know it's not actually Crampy stealing this crap, but it's very
But we're the leader of Grass-Eating Kingdom. we should be able to give back to the community here.
If you're coming around to beg for a meal, you've come to the wrong cat. I'd take a free meal if I could get one, too. Sorry. Oh, I'm dying of hunger.
Oh, gosh. Eat. Food.
Okay. You know what? Let's eat the crustacean, because it... Wait, I can't eat it?
What?
Okay.
Is this a non-edible item? Oh, no.
I thought I could eat it. Alright, let's... Okay. Now we'll take out the thistle.
We can't have ourselves dying again. Then Crampy would take more of our stuff.
That's for me? Thanks. Alright, that's all Garlic has to say to me. Thanks. Still 2 stars. But, we did kind of mess up in the beginning by giving it to Daisy. What else do I got left in my inventory? Magpie? Let's give it to Jag.
Jag deserves a magpie.
If you think you can bully me because of my size, think again. Jag is no stranger to a good fight. Kind of a skinny guy, isn't he?
Yeah, a bit!
I trained my whole life to protect weaker cats from any and all threats. If you judge me by my size, it will be your undoing. What a great guy. You really didn't have to, Petunia. Thanks. Oh, I was gonna get that snake for Talon, but I'm kind of dying. Yeah.
You know, they really just don't appreciate our love.
They don't.
No. On a side note, and completely unrelated to the fact that Charlotte does not appreciate our love, I think Charlotte is one of my 2 favorite cats.
Charlotte's fun.
Yeah, Charlotte is very fun. And for precisely the opposite reason, Buttercup is also one of my favorites.
The leaves are changing and going back to normal. They were way too colorful for way too long. It makes me angry. If everything in the world were monochrome and neutral, I'd be a lot happier.
Thank you, Charlotte.
Thank you, Charlotte. I hate colors.
That's a very nice sentiment. Thank you for sharing your deep opinions with us.
Imagine being a frog. Yeah, take that.
Ah, dead frog, yes.
I did see a snake around this area before. Oh.
Oh goodness.
It was golden, so I didn't want to get too close and scare it away, but as it turns out, I got too close. I didn't get close enough. Somewhere around here there was a snake. I guess I am minorly worried about just getting killed by the snake again, but...
Well, if you heal yourself up ahead of time, it shouldn't be too big of an issue, but you're currently surrounded by two crabs, so, you know.
Yeah.
Being careful.
There we go.
Dead!
This is what hunting is like in the first game.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, it's not what hunting is supposed to be like in the first game.
It's just often what it is like.
Yeah.
Perfect. Now you have frog.
That's an interesting thing out in the water that I don't think I have in range. Oh, can't go down here. But there is a little path.
Hypothetically, could you just swim out into the middle of the ocean?
I could, but I would drown.
And gosh, darn it, we're here
again. Steal my stuff again.
Yeah. Don't give Crampy more of your stuff.
Free lizard. Helen likes snakes. Was there something else that she liked?
Snake lilies, amethysts, independence.
Oh, that's Charlotte, right?
If you're looking for Charlotte.
No,
if you're not
Talon.
Looking for Charlotte, if you're looking for Talon, Talon likes snakes, honeycomb, and strategy.
Honeycomb, huh?
I have no idea where that would come from.
I'd imagine that's not in season, if anything. Strategy. I found some strategy outside for you, Charlotte.
Here's some strategy, Talon.
Alright, what's this? I think I saw this on stream.
I am the steward of a great treasure. I watch over it until the one who can claim it will come at last. Do you wish to challenge me for it?
Yes.
Then prepare yourself. The challenge is about to commence. I'll ask you questions, and you'll answer them! Woohoo! Correctly answer 3 questions, and I'll give you your reward! But if you miss 3 questions, you're out! Here we go! Question 1. True or false? Cats can dream in their sleep.
I'm going to assume that's true.
That is correct! Question 2. True or false? A cat uses their tail to communicate their current mood. That is correct! Question 3. True or false? Calico cats are more likely to be male than female.
Interesting.
That is correct! Astounding, superb, Petunia, you've won! Great work! I'll distribute the prize now! I've been your host, thanks for playing!
Oh boy, the
so that was not what I expected from that rock. You found a power paw! You are filled with vigor by the ancient token. Your run speed has increased. Faster.
Slightly faster. Where's that snake that killed me last time? Come here, snake. There's a rat.
But is it a bunny, or is it a hare?
Oh, it's probably a hare. No, it's a rabbit.
Oh, okay. Lovely.
Which is a bunny. From my perspective, anyway. Just can't own anything with Crampy around.
Yeah, I know. Maybe it would be better to put stuff in chests so Crampy can't steal it.
Possibly. Or on our floor.
That is also a great option.
I love, in the first game, just dumping everything on my floor.
It's a great opportunity for decoration.
We have a tiny little drop shadow behind us.
Oh, yeah!
Lizards, I think that goes on the floor.
That sounds like a lovely idea. Oh, every type of prey is going to be upside down.
I guess that's how it designates they're dead, huh?
I'm sure, yeah.
Oops, I picked up the lizards. Oh, that opened the storage. How much of something can we store in our storage, anyway? We've got 6 pages of it, we can just dump everything in here.
Yeah, okay. Go ahead.
But I think it's funny to leave things on the floor, so...
It is! No, absolutely. Go ahead.
I'm going to eat this.
People want us to give Charlotte the void marrow, by the way.
Okay, well, if she hates it,
you guys are
sabotaging
fault.
Our beautiful relationship.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, what are you looking at? You think I'm going to be impressed by your title? Oh, here comes the boss cat. Let's all fall in line and be good little cats and do everything you say. No, that's not my thing. I'm nobody's puppet. I do what I want, and if you have a problem with that, then too bad.
See, I want to give Crampy or Charlotte the void marrow, but I think currently I can't give anybody anything. Well, not- oh wait, no, I can give it to Charlotte, you're right.
Yeah.
I can give it to Charlotte. Okay, let's go. I don't think this is a good idea.
Oh boy.
Well, I see how it is. That's totally uncalled for, Petunia.
Yeah, no, Charlotte, no likey the bone, the void marrow. No, no.
I wonder who does. I wonder if anyone does.
Does anyone like void marrow? Does anyone say, ah yes, the residue of dead phantom cats, this is exactly what I've always wanted?
I think this is definitely going to be a thing that we're not going to learn until, like, the game is out, you know, when people
probably not, yeah.
I mean, we could always, like, you know, do some ask. Research ourselves.
But, yeah.
On who likes void marrow, we could do the void marrow ultimate tests.
Just go around to everyone, reset the day 100 times until you find someone who likes void marrow.
Yeah. It's our who hates void marrow save file. And the answer is going to be everybody.
Everyone hates void marrow. No one appreciates it when you hand them residue of dead phantom cat. Who would have guessed?
Sunny, if I gave you void marrow, would you still be my friend?
Yes, of course, but we're at a very high friendship level already.
I see. So if some random stranger hands you void marrow, you're not-
I really don't think good. I would appreciate it, no. How about you? You like some good void marrow?
Hmm. You know, it depends. Does it smell? Does it stick?
This is true. It seems like a sort of gloppy substance from before. And apparently it has occasional helium-like properties where it's lighter than oxygen and will float, but only in tiny specks. I mean, it could be an interesting fluid to examine, honestly.
Sounds like some dangerous stuff, in my opinion.
I mean, probably, but you like flooding lava, so, you know.
Oh yeah, we should go take a sip of substances. That lava, shouldn't we?
No, no, that was not an invitation.
Just you know, go and take a little tiny, tiny little
sip. No, no little dips in the lava. No little dips in the lava. Just, don't get the Petunia killed.
You know, if it's spicy, we can drink some milk or something.
Yeah, but if it's spicy, Crampy will have to revitalize us. And Crampy takes a pretty sizable portion of our stuff in order to do that.
You think that Crampy can bring someone back after they fall in lava?
I think he's very talented.
It's a little house sparrow looking guys.
Yay!
Just to fill up my inventory with little creatures. A thrush, a sparrow. Have we been everywhere on the map? Let me look at the map.
I think so?
Have we been to this lake all the way over here?
I don't remember, actually. We might want to go just in case.
Let's go check out the lake.
I always like to go out and walk to the lake at 12 a.m.
Yeah. I mean, it's the perfect time for it. And
naturally.
What do we get for sleeping? Experience that I don't know how to use? Yeah, don't worry about it. We're good.
Petunia don't need no sleep. That would be silly.
She doesn't need to sleep because she is a talented individual. And she doesn't need to get better at her skills.
Very talented,
because
yes.
She can just get good.
And she's already good.
Yeah.
She's already so much better than she was, 2 hours ago? 2 hours ago she forgot to eat and couldn't hunt and died on her first day.
And look, our friends are here even.
Yeah. Oh, I love you, friends. Hi, friends. Did you know that a friend of ours didn't appreciate it when we took a part of your body and gave it to them? I can't imagine why.
I think Charlotte needs to get over herself. If somebody gives you void marrow from the heart, you need to just take a look and think,
I mean, be grateful, Charlotte. We went out and killed a man just for you.
Is this the lake or is this the one next? Yep, this is the lake.
That's the lake, yeah.
Nope. No toad for me. Unless. Nope, no toad for me.
Oh boy. Yes!
Gotcha. Yeah, I haven't seen any more snakes. They seem vaguely rare. Maybe if I went back and forth in the one place that I know that they spawn. Like, just over and over again, trying to get one to come up.
Just to give to Talon?
Well, I don't know. I guess I want to see what she says when you give her something she wants.
That's fair.
And apparently nobody likes crabs or wants to eat them. But you know what? I think
you know, someone might like crabs.
Maybe I need to get like a crab cutter, like a little crab knife or something, and then I can feed everyone crab. And they can understand that when I give them the crab, I'm doing it only out of love and appreciation. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I changed my mind. No one likes crab.
Alright, so I think I saw Snake up here.
We're not giving Talon the Void Mirror. We want her to like us.
I think it's unlikely anyone's going to want the Void Mirror, no matter how tough they act. That's just my opinion, though. Alright, so I definitely saw snakes on the beach. I don't know which beach exactly, but...
A beach.
Yes. Some beach somewhere. And it might have been this one. Hold on 1 second.
You cannot hear it because I am on push to talk right now, but I am bopping along to this music. This is very good music. I appreciate it greatly. Oh, no. You can't hear me singing the music.
Oh.
In boop-a-doop-boop, so, you know, not... not quality singing.
My brain is going at half speed. I need more sleep than this. I always promise myself I'll go to bed earlier and then fail to follow through. Shoot, I should just give up trying. Garlic is a very relatable character.
Garlic's a little bit of a pessimist. I think they should care about themselves more.
Garlic, you want to eat an entire rabbit? You don't want to hang on to it? Okay, I guess. I can't think of anything to do with it, though. You eat it! Garlic,
eat
you said
it!
You wanted free food yesterday, come on!
Garlic, you dum-dum! Eat the food we provide you!
Carlos, like, I don't want to do anything. I want to sit around all day. Okay, I'll give you some food. You can sit around all day. I don't know what to do with this, though. Alright. You know what? You want a trout? You want a trout, Talon? You are a bird of prey, after all. Oh my god! She hates the trout, too!
What the heck?
Are you trying to make me mad? What? Do you want to fight?
Oh no, we've made our enemy.
So you're a smart one, are you? You'll back off if you know what's good for you. Yeah, I need to rectify this somehow.
Yeah, quickly.
Oh my goodness. Nothing's good enough for Talon.
Talon, I'm sorry.
Might as well have given them the Void Marrow or whatever. Alright, I need to find a snake. I need to make it out to them. I need to get killed by a snake.
Snake! Please! Me, snake. I know it can be quite intimidating to have killed someone before, but we really don't mean you. Oh, hi friends, it's you again. Hello. See, we weren't looking for you just now.
Yeah, don't feel like dealing with my friends right now. Maybe if I crouch, it'll show me what's on the screen. What do we got? Mouse and magpie. Sparrow, squirrel, mouse. Oh, a question mark. That might be it. Yes, it is it.
Yeah! Snake!
Oh, jeez.
Oh.
Ah!
Oh!
Okay,
Oh, but this is a fightable. So, you're gonna need heat.
Let's,
herb.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't die to snake twice in a row.
Alright, snake. Okay.
Yeah!
All right,
snake!
Let's see if we can
patch anything up with Talon at all.
We might not be able to give Talon a gift right now, but
possibly, yeah. Because it's the same day, and also, she doesn't like us at all.
Talon feels a great hatred. It's starting to feel like you're trying to bribe me.
We are.
Yeah, it's true. maybe tomorrow we'll try giving Talon a snake.
Hey, I was watching you run around earlier. What do you do all day? I got paws, I got claws. When I walk... Oh, sorry. Is this supposed to be a song? When I walk by, it will make you pause. Oh, boy.
I can't tell if it's a song or they're flirting with us.
Oh, sorry. I was just singing to myself. That was definitely a song. I'm sorry. I should have taken it. I got paws, I got claws. Something, it will make you pause.
When I walk by, it will make you
pause. When I walk by, it will make you pause.
This is a bad song. This is a very bad song. I should catch it better.
I got claws. When I walk by, it will make you pause.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Whoa. I'm not so sure about that.
Lainey hates mouse.
Lena hates mouse.
We are ruining everyone.
You hate everyone and everyone hates you.
I don't hate everyone.
You again? No! Why don't you go bother someone else for once?
God, we're just ruining our relationships with all these people.
I'll see what Lainey likes.
Okay.
Lainey likes marigolds, diamonds, and painting.
Okay, we've got.
You have marigolds.
We can patch this up.
Give them that tomorrow.
Hello, Petunia. I trust that you're staying busy today. You look absolutely famished. You should fetch a mouse or something before you waste away. By the way, on the topic of mice, in case it might interest you, Lainey really hates them, so you know, don't ever give one of those to her.
Oh, I guess I shouldn't.
You know who we haven't talked to since the start of the game?
Who?
Champ.
Okay, let's go see if Champ wants to usurp us.
Huh? You talking to me? I'm busy practicing. I can't really talk for long. If I sacrificed my whole day just to talk to you, I'd never get anything done.
Never mind, I remembered why we hadn't talked to him.
Here you go, champ. Oh my god!
I'm not that dense. I know exactly what you're trying to say by this little gesture of yours. Disgusting. Everyone in camp hates us.
It takes nothing.
No!
It takes nothing to make these people hate me. All I have to do is offer them the wrong kind of food at the buffet.
No.
Oh, what does Champ
say? No!
I really don't have time for this. Don't you have something more important to be doing instead of pestering me? I don't know how you get under my skin so quickly, but you managed to find a way. The way is thrush. What could you possibly want?
Oh my god.
Thrush okay. is the way to any man's
so we've
evil
got a
heart.
List now. We've got
oh yeah.
Talon, Lainey, and Champ, and they all
hate us.
Petunia's been nothing but nice to these people.
Well, obviously not. Petunia hasn't taken the time to learn what they care about.
Look at her. She's so distressed. She's sitting now.
I know.
So, Buttercup.
Are you talking to me? Sorry, I startle easily. I mean, if you have something to say, I guess I'll listen, but I don't have much to contribute. I'm not very interesting. That's what everybody says. Sorry.
Who has been bullying this kid?
It's not anyone in particular, exactly. It's just... Oh, right. Get away from me! No!
I can't believe
I'm
this.
Flipping! Oh my gosh!
Everything I pick is the wrong thing to do. Oh.
No.
They hate me.
Okay,
all
what is Buttercup? What does Buttercup like? Buttercup likes moths, shrews, staying home, dislikes lavender and loud noises.
Oh, she has
no! She won't even talk to you! Stop making fun of me!
Oh my god.
No!
Should I even try giving these people presents anymore?
I don't know.
Spark, how do you feel about sparrows?
Spark, do you hate sparrows?
What's up? Catch any bugs today? Oh, that's kinda neat.
Okay, so Spark's normal.
Wanna go on a run with me? I'm hoping to catch some ladybugs while I'm out.
Oh, does, give them a ladybug.
Does this game have, like, a... So in Stardew Valley, if I remember... Is it Stardew Valley? I don't know. At least one game I've played that's been this-esque. I've been able to look and see what people like and dislike from my menu. But I don't think that that's the case. Oh, how am I ever gonna remember this?
Okay, well, I mean, I've got part of it. It's cataloged in my memory. Spark likes bugs. Spark really likes bugs. We should give them a bug.
Okay.
Spark also likes lavender. Where Buttercup dislikes lavender, so we probably should have given the lavender to them.
I can't believe we have 4 cats who hate us now.
This is more than I hoped to have. At least Charlotte doesn't hate us anymore.
Yeah, I guess. Okay, Buttercup, did, Champ, Lainey, and
Talon. Lainey and Talon.
All
yeah.
hate us. I have no idea what to give to Buttercup or Champ.
Oh.
But
okay. Buttercup would like it if you gave her a moth or a shrew.
Okay, we can find a shrew. Not up here though. Alright, how about we keep playing until about 9 and then we'll off stream in about 15 minutes.
Sounds great.
So if the chat wants us to do anything more... let us know.
Give Bob a fish, says someone.
Okay.
Bob likes fish. So we won't make another enemy if we do that, hopefully, please.
Okay, let's give Bob a fish. Do we have a fish in our inventory right now? Yep, we got salmon.
Salmon! Okay. Mackerel! Various things. Also, people want us to give Spark a bug.
We already gave Spark something, unfortunately, so we gotta wait until tomorrow for that.
And, tomorrow we're gonna need to make amends for a lot of things.
Okay. Okay, Bob, here we go. We can't mess this up.
Well now, how you doing, Petunia? I'd enjoy a friendly chat today. I've just been keeping to myself. I hope not to get in your way. Old Bob knows their place, don't you worry. I can't do accents. Oh my, you sure do know me well. I really appreciate this, Petunia. Thank you.
Alright, so, we have one friend. It's Bob and Garlic.
Yahoo! Probably. Is it actually a new day? Are we capable of giving Talon a snake now?
We can see, but I don't think so. We'll know if the explanation point is yellow around Talon. Nope, white.
Okay.
Let's see if we can find a shrew. We have Golden Seal, so we can... we have Marigold, so we can make up with Lane.
Yeah.
Champ
likes foxglove, rats, and working out, but we can't give them working out.
Well, you can give anyone working out if you try hard
enough. Yeah, but do you really want to, is the thing, though.
Good question.
Jag also loves licorice, and people want you to give them licorice.
Do I have any?
I don't know.
Is Jag free? Did I not give Jag something today?
I am just relaying this from the chat.
I'm gonna believe everything the chat says. I have absolutely no idea.
It's your fault if we do things wrong, chat. Everything is your fault.
I'm blaming the chat for everything I've done. Except I've done everything on my own and the chat has nothing to do with it.
The chat is exactly the reason why we've made four enemies, despite the fact that you're the one who chose the four gifts for them. Oh, you also apparently have a moth. Do you have a moth?
Okay, let's see. What do we got? What do we got in our inventory? We have a sphinx moth. So
that's great. We can give a sphinx moth to Buttercup. Right,
so we got something
Legacy.
For Buttercup. We got something for Talon. We have Marigold.
Marigold for Lainey.
And all we need is the shrew.
Foxglove or rats.
Foxglove or rats? Oh. I think we probably have a rat in our den. Because I caught a lot of rats. I mean, it could have been that Crampy just coincidentally ate all of my rats.
All the rats. You know, he might have a hankering for rats. You don't know.
Yeah, that gives him an excuse to just take them out of my inventory. Like, looks like they have some rats here.
I mean, he's a doctor. He can do whatever he darn well pleases.
People hate me so much. Where am I? Oh, far away. Okay. This is Petunia, the incredibly offensive leader of Grass Eating Kingdom.
Everyone here hates her. I'm sorry, Petunia, we did not raise you well.
Our daughter's a mess, honey.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean for it to turn out this way.
Okay. Wait, where was I going back? Oh, yeah, to check my den for rats. I think that's one there. Or maybe not. Let's see. No, it was a shrew. Well, I'll check my box for rats. Because I swear I got one. No, looks like I am not having any rats. What was the other thing you liked? Foxglove?
Foxglove, yeah.
Foxglove is super poisonous to cats.
Well, Champ likes the challenge. You know?
I would like some poison, please.
It's my favorite poison. Well, I mean, to be fair, it's not entirely clear that Champ wants to eat the foxglove. Maybe they just want to use it for something.
Yeah.
Yeah? I mean, who's to say, really?
There's another snake up there if I want to feel dangerous. Thank you.
Okay, no, I don't feel dangerous.
What? Champ apparently likes shrew, and you have a shrew in your den.
Oh.
Apparently.
Okay, well...
I don't have that information, but okay.
You know, I'll believe it for now.
I will choose to believe it, even though that's Buttercup's thing.
Well, they can like the same thing. They even live right next to each other.
That's true. Maybe you have dinner dates sometimes that aren't necessarily dates.
Let's go to sleep. Okay. And, it's now 7 a.m. Time to give everyone garbage. Hi, Talon. Don't know what I did to deserve this, but I'll gladly take it.
Oh, thank freaking goodness. Okay. Make up with Lainey.
Okay.
Since, you know, they're right next to me. Next, you can chat first. Considering Talon wouldn't talk to us yesterday.
One second.
Champ is, in fact, going to poison us all. It is a secret plot. We're not supposed to know about it yet.
You really have a way of irritating me, you know that?
Thanks, Talon.
Am I in push to talk or not? You really have a way of irritating me, you know that? If you have something important to say, spit it out.
We just gave you a snake. Be a little more grateful. Wait, you can't. Oh. Okay.
Marigold? Marigold, right?
Yeah. Okay. Marigold for Lainey. Hey, that's perfect. I love it. Okay, good. We are now on speaking terms with Lainey. Oh gosh. I got paws, I got claws. When I walk by, it'll make you pause. I fell off the end there. Oh, sorry. I was just singing to myself. Badly. I'll come up with a better one later.
Wow. Okay, who else do we got on our list? Champ and Buttercup, right?
Champ and Buttercup, yes.
We need to restore our faith in them. Sorry, my cats are drinking water loudly behind me.
I cannot hear it personally.
Oh, good. But,
yeah.
Alright, Champ likes voles, according to the
Champ
chat.
Champ likes shrews, according to the chat.
Oh, shrews?
Yeah.
Okay, I need to go back for a shrew. I got a vole.
Shrew.
Uh-oh, I've got mail.
Oh.
Maybe it's hate mail.
Did Crampy kill you again? Did Crampy mail you again?
I wonder. Let's see.
Petunia, I don't know what your issue is, but if you have a problem with me, then I have a problem with you. I am not the cat you want to have on your bad side. You best shape up quick and stop being so selfish.
He mailed me
Champ
rocks.
Champ has sent you rock debris.
He mailed me rocks.
It seems like this would be more effort on your end than on ours. Good day to you, Petunia. Today is the Spring Festival. I sure hope you'll join us at the Festival Plaza, just north of town, for the festivities. There's games to be played and prizes to be won. I've attached some complimentary festival tokens to the letter. See you there.
Okay. Now we have a shrew. That was what we wanted, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Hypothetically, if the chat is correct. You don't need it? You sure?
Okay.
Oh, that's it. But we're on speaking terms, yeah.
I've been watching you run about all day. You must be tired from all that hard work. I'd share something with you, but I think hunger's a good motivator. Sharpens the mind, kicks you into gear.
I can't stand this guy.
I don't like this guy either, but he's kind of fun to voice.
Okay.
Buttercup. I want to make sure we have this right. She likes shrews and moths.
Alright, we just gave away our shrew, so it's gotta be the moth.
Moth it is.
Oh, wow! These are awesome! Thanks, Petunia. All's forgiven. Are you talking to me? Are you eating well? I'd share my bowl, but I only have one.
Okay, and they wanted us to give licorice to Jag.
Yes.
Jack. You really didn't have to, Petunia. Thanks.
Somewhere in her heart, Petunia will always have a strange longing to be with Jag.
Hey, kid. You've got to stop and eat once in a while, you know. If you whittle away to nothing, what will the rest of us do? Plenty of prey to hunt in the wild. I suggest you find something fast, okay? Oh, looks like I'm starving.
You are starving. Three cats have commented on it. So, to be clear, we no longer have any enemies?
I think so. Let's check.
Jag is 2 stars now.
He is? Oh, wow! I didn't even realize that their stars could go up.
Yeah.
I thought maybe on the demo they wouldn't.
I just noticed it when you were talking just then.
Wow, okay.
We don't have any enemies, and we have one friend-ish, mostly.
Kind of.
So, friendly acquaintance.
Let's go say hi to Garlic. I guess let's Jag is the only one of our friends that we haven't horrifically offended to the point where
that's true. Yeah.
Oh, what is it now? Did I mess something up again? I don't want to get in trouble. Some cats never catch a break, and I'm one of them. Life has a way of beating you down, and it's hard to find a way to stand back up again. That's okay, though. It's more comfortable down on the ground anyway. I'll stay low so I don't get knocked down again.
Garlic likes turtles and thistle and sleeping in. If we'd like to gift them.
I don't think we have to. We have thistle. That's for me. Thanks. Alright, Garlic's still 1 star, though.
Yeah. Also, people have been telling us to talk to Spark and Glimmer for a while.
Okay, we can talk to Glimmer.
Spark, get the bug, and Glimmer.
To what do I owe the pleasure of your esteemed presence?
There are so few cats whose destinies will lead them to greatness. I speak to you in confidence, but you and I are 2 of that kind. Truly, you must have always known deep in your heart that your path will lead you to glory. I have felt it too. But we must not lord it over the other cats. Some are the jealous type. Share not the words I have said.
Yeah, she's
Glimmer also apparently likes toads.
Do we have any toad? We've got frog. Do you think
frogs? Frog might count. Let's try again, frog. Please don't hate us.
This has brightened my day. That much is crystal clear.
Oh, lovely. Okay.
All right. So we did not give offend Glimmer for giving them.
We did not offend Glimmer.
We're giving them an off-brand toad.
Yeah, and we also need to give a second bug to Spark eventually. But Bob.
Well, now, how are you doing, Petunia? I would enjoy a friendly chat today.
Well, now, thank you very much. This just made my day. How you been doing, Petunia? I've been all right myself, getting on as I always have. It's a nice place to live out here in the Wildwood. Okay. But
so I think the obvious end goal here is to maximally befriend everyone and only marry one of them.
Do you think a black ladybug's an insult?
I don't think so.
What's up? Catch any bugs today?
Well, as a matter of fact.
You're the best, Petunia!
We take good care of your child, Ember.
Remind me what your name is again? I'm horrible with names. Ember is always telling me to repeat cats' names in my head whenever I meet someone, but how am I supposed to remember and listen at the same time? Knowing names is important for when I take over the shop, but I am simply not good at it.
Oh, we now forgot about Charlotte. Oh boy.
Well, it's okay. We can do this. We can do this. What are we gonna give Charlotte, though?
I don't know. Lizard? Well. Yeah, I guess.
I mean.
Well.
Every time
she hates ladybugs and social interaction. It doesn't say anything else. Frick! No!
Hey, get that thing away from me!
But doesn't hate us.
I'm what they call bad-mannered. That's what my parents called me anyway. They never did figure out what's wrong with me. But I don't care. Couldn't care less what you think. I'm trying to live my life. You and all the others are trying to tread all over me for it. Step off, or I'll push back.
Charlotte likes snake lilies, but not necessarily snakes.
That was a lizard, so who knows what she likes.
Yeah, who the heck knows about lizards.
Alright, let's see what's, let's peek up here.
Festival! Oh, I like the music here, too.
Well, it's the last day of spring, so yeah. Supposedly it's time for the festival, but the festival doesn't seem to be going on yet. Maybe we gotta talk to Coco?
Perhaps, yes. Oh, what?
What?
Oh, what?
Oh, I think
that. Boy, this sure is a rip-roaring festival.
Maybe this is a bug?
Potentially.
Because time has stopped.
And, Oh. That's not great. Huh. Okay.
Well, I think this is about where I was gonna end it anyways, so...
Yeah. It's entirely possible the festivals don't exist yet because demo.
Well, how about this? We could stream... Sunny, would you be up for streaming this again sometime?
Of course!
Okay. Well, what we'll do is we'll leave this video up, and in the comments, people can tell us who they want us to romance, and we'll let them decide.
That is an incredibly fair decision. Yes, I agree with this.
Okay. I'm gonna leave the festival because I can't do anything here.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna save the game.
That sounds like a great idea.
Wow, that's sad.
Game progress saved.
Okay. I will now stop streaming. Goodbye, chat. I'll see you guys.
Goodbye!
They want me to look at the pool TV.
They
won't do that. I can do that. I can watch television.
Pool TV. Clear skies all day long. Right now, it's sunny outside. Tomorrow, expect clear skies all day long. We're getting sunny all the time.
Oh, wait.
While you stare into the depths, you can hear kindly voices calling out to you with words of wisdom. Hello, Petunia. How are you? I'd like to tell you more about sleeping today. Naturally, cats are accustomed to sleeping whenever it fits their schedule. Some cats prefer to sleep in the evening when the world is dark, and others prefer sleeping in the day when the sun is out. You are free to sleep whenever you would like in order to recharge and reflect. You will find that sleeping has several benefits. Small wounds may be healed by taking a few hours to relax in your den.
And by sleeping, your brain has time to process and apply the lessons you've learned throughout your day, netting you some bonus experience points. However, you will not gain such benefits if you sleep all the time. If you aren't tired, you will not heal nor gain experience points when you rest. Happy dreams! Let peace be the anchor that stays your soul when others see their tempers flare.
Well, others do tend to see their tempers flare.
Quite a lot, yes. Now all is silent. Good evening, cats of the grass-eating kingdom. It is 10 p.m. on Spring 10, Year 1. It is the last day of spring. Wow, that really flew by. It is your chance to catch last chance to catch ladybugs and moths before they hibernate for the year. There's a special event happening today. The Spring Festival is taking place at the Festival Plaza. It starts at 10 a.m. Let's celebrate together.
I guess I missed it.
Yeah. That's all the news I have for now. I'm signing off. Thanks for watching. We now return to Tall Tales, brought to you by the Public Cat Broadcasting Committee. We are thankful for our sponsors and donations from cats like you, who help us keep Tall Tales on the air.
I'm glad we get PBS.
It's great to have PBS. I love PBS. Have you ever watched a ladybug? Graceful critters, they glide through the air as though nothing could ever bother them. Their radiantly colored shells, dotted with so many spots, shine like paintings against the canvas-like flowers of the meadows. Of course, ladybugs are known for their great variety. Brilliant shades of red, yellow, and of black are common sights in the springtime. But what if I told you that some cats believe there is another type of ladybug, one that has been around since the beginning, but which is rarely seen by feline eyes? Yes, it's true. Of all the myths and legends that have been passed down from generation to generation, none is more well known than the story of the blue ladybug. According to tradition, the first ladybugs were all blue, you see. Blue as the sky on a warm summer day. Blue as the depths of the deepest lake. Blue as blue paint, minus the black spots, of course. And why were they blue, you might ask? It is an odd color for a bug to be. Well, if you believe the old tales, the ladybugs were citizens of a lofty city in the skies, nestled among the clouds. They used their blue shells as a natural form of camouflage, and they painted their city the same bright blue pigment to keep it secret and unnoticed by their ground-dwelling animals like you and me. However, some of the ladybugs of the Cloud City became old and fragile, and they slowly drifted down to Earth. In their weakened state, they were not strong enough to fly back up to the city of their people. Others believe that there was a civil war amongst the ladybugs of the clouds, and the members of the losing faction were stripped of their stronger, sky-gliding wings and cast down from the skies. And thus they became stuck here, destined to live near the ground for all time. As the long years passed, their brilliant blue garnets began to fade into other strange colors, reds and yellows and near black grays. What an absurd story. I certainly have never seen a blue ladybug in all my years studying the creatures. And now we close the book on the tale of the blue ladybug. Come back next season to hear me tell another strange story.
Okay, and with that...